this afternoon for the Rangers of Northwestern Oklahoma. Clarkson, straight drop, now forced out of the pocket. In trouble, sack! There it finally is. We've been waiting on that sack, and it is big Rovell Carter.
Well, how the you know, he's been getting away from a lot of them. That time, Rovell Carter doesn't get his arms on him. He just kind of wraps him up and lays down on top of him. You're not getting away that time.
The first half, Hayden Mallory scales behind him. Mallory's going to pass, got time, going to the end zone. Intercepted! It goes back to Washington. Coming up with it, Hayden Lester, the senior, out of Warren.
Lester with the interception in the end zone, and he played that one perfectly.
Hayden Lassiter, the senior out of Warren, is his holder. Here we go. Snap. Hold. Kick. Trying to get there. It is good! It's good! It's good!
Oh, don't you love this celebration on the Washington side? Everybody with their hands in the air saying it is good. Gabe Goodman from Arkadelphia nailed it.
There's Edwards back, and there he may go! 45-50, 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown. He just went all the way. He went 72 yards. Second down, 10 yards needed for a first down. Now Connor Flanagan goes in motion right to left. Out of the shotgun, called quarterback keeper. Running room, 30, 25, 20. Zaylen Falls, Justin Dean deep for Washita. After 21 months away, Washita football is back. Falls at the 6, cuts over to the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Hits the far sideline to the 30. He's to the 20. He's to the 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Kendall Gibbons right up the middle. First down, Washington. He's going. He's going. He's still going. He's going to the promised land. It's Kendall Gibbons. It's a touchdown, Washington. Near side. That's the wide side of the field. Protect this time. He looks this way. Can't find anybody. Sack! Back at the 29-yard line, it was Damian McDonald. Going to be the direct snap to T.J. Cole. Isaac Edwards set to his left. Cole looking up the middle of the field, finds running room as he cuts back right. He's going to be to the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, no flags down. Touchdown, T.J. Cole. Touchdown, Washington.
Well, he just got around that edge, Rex, and once he got to that edge, you knew he was going.
Tigers trailing 21 to nothing, but with a 2nd and 7 now, with their deepest penetration so far at the 33. T.J. Cole, good running room, gets away at the 20, the 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown, T.J. Cole. The Tigers are finally on the board. They set on the near hash mark. They are going to pass. Looking, Morse has time. It's batted in the air, and it's intercepted. It is intercepted by Washington, coming up with it on the first possession. Terrell Gibson. Touchdown, Washington.
Way up at the buzzer. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is. We'll be right back.
received by White. His communication, and Tigers win!
And they're going to send around Allen. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is!
Court to the three-point line. Thornton underneath to Van Zandt. Layup at the buzzer. It's good. It's good. Wichita storms the court.
Welcome to the Aurora Rundown. I'm Brody Kriegel. Wichita's fall sports teams are getting closer to championship month. Teams are looking to end October strong as many position themselves for postseason play. We begin with football as the top five Wichita football team moved to 8-0 after beating Southern Arkansas in the Murphy USA Classic 63-31. After trailing the Mule Riders 14-7 in the first quarter, the Tigers went ahead and never looked back, scoring 9 total touchdowns. This is the third game this season where Wichita has scored more than 60 points, and the first time that this has happened since 1942. Behind another solid effort from the offensive line, running back T.J. Cole dominated the ballgame with 230 yards rushing and tied a GAC record with 6 rushing touchdowns. Cole's second consecutive 200-yard rushing game led him to back-to-back GAC Offensive Player of the Week awards. The Tigers have a quick turnaround as they will play their final regular season home game of the season on Thursday night as East Central comes to Cliff Harris Stadium for a 6 p.m. kickoff. Senior night ceremonies will take place before the game. Women's soccer is entering the final week of the regular season, with Wichita currently tied for first place in the conference after a 4-4 draw with Harding on Tuesday. The top team will host the conference tournament starting next week. The tie with Harding was the team's fourth straight tie as last Saturday, the women finished in a 0-0 draw against Northwestern Oklahoma State. The last two matches of the regular season will determine whether Wichita, Southwestern Oklahoma State, or Oklahoma Baptist will win the regular season title and host the conference tournament. November 3rd and 5th, Wichita wraps regular season play Thursday in Ada, Oklahoma against East Central. Both Southwestern and Oklahoma Baptist played Thursday and Saturday. Last Thursday, volleyball completed a season sweep of Henderson State, beating the Reddies 3-0. Riley Brazil led in kills with 10, and Wichita had a season-high 11 blocks, with Haley Fairchild recording 8, which is also a team high for the season. This win followed a 3-0 sweep of UAM the week before, and made this the Tigers' fifth straight win by scores of 3-0. The win against Henderson State clinched the Tigers a berth in the GAC Volleyball Tournament in early November. Wichita will wrap up regular season play next week with 2 matches. The final home match of the season will be Tuesday, November 1st, in the senior night match versus Arkansas Tech. In other Tiger sports, the swim teams lost their first Battle of the Ravine meet at Henderson, and men's soccer is set to play its last home match and honor its seniors this Saturday at 2 o'clock p.m. versus Harding at Cluck Field. That's all for the Roar Rundown. Back to you.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
I've heard people say, oh, a cheetah.
Oh, Wichita.
At cheetah.
Oh, a cheetah.
Is it pronounced oh, a cheetah?
Searching for Wichita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Wichita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Wichita.
Wichita.
It's Wichita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Wichita, people. It's Wichita.
Wichita.
Our town,
A place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch. A place to sit back and watch the world go by. A place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Start your holiday season at Ouachita Baptist University's 30th Annual Festival of Christmas. With new music, classic favorites, fun characters, and stirring moments, there is something magical for everyone. Whether it's your 13th time or your first, you do not want to miss this exciting tradition December 2nd and 3rd. Join us for Festival of Christmas. Tickets are on sale now at obu.edu/boxoffice.
This is the Week 8 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell. East Central is now on a 6-game win streak for the first time since 1984 after its 42-28 win over Southwestern Oklahoma State and a 99th meeting between the two teams. With the game tied 14-14 in the second quarter, ECU scored 28 straight points to build a 35-14 lead midway through the third quarter. Swasu added two touchdowns to set the 14-point margin, but the Tigers never lost control. Kenny Hearns here threw for 239 yards and three touchdowns, including this 88-yard touchdown pass to Jaquan Lincoln on the first play of the drive early in the third quarter. Here's Mike Manos of X Factor Radio with the call.
And they will have it at their own 12-yard line after the punt by Van Winkle. Back to pass, Kenny going long down the middle of the field. Wide open, Link at the 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, down the sidelines, 10, 5, touchdown, Tigers! 88 yards to number one, and the Tigers blow it open.
Ouachita running back T.J. Cole put together his second consecutive game of 200-plus yards rushing and tied a GAC record with 6 rushing touchdowns, helping number four Ouachita move to 8-0 with a 63-31 win over SAU in the Murphy USA Classic in El Dorado, Arkansas. Southern Arkansas held an early 14-7 lead, but the Tigers took control with the ground game and built a 35-17 lead themselves. SAU would cut the Ouachita lead to 11 in the third quarter, but a strong fourth quarter from the Tigers put the game out of reach. Cole's fifth touchdown of the game came early in the fourth quarter and gave Ouachita a 49-31 lead. Here's Rex Nelson on the Ouachita Football Network.
On the direct snap, it will go to the senior All-American, T.J. Cole. Cole calls for the snap, takes it, goes over right tackle to the two. Cole to the one. Cole to the land of milk and honey. Touchdown, Ouachita, with 10:52 left in the fourth quarter.
It was a high-scoring affair in Monticello Saturday as Harding outscored UAM 56-43. The Bison's strong ground game resulted in 4 touchdowns, but it was a 75-yard touchdown pass and a 97-yard fumble return for a score that put separation between the Bisons and the Boll Weevils. Harding led 28-21 at halftime and extended the lead on a 75-yard touchdown from Cole Keelon to Cage City with just under 10 minutes left in the third quarter. Clark Griffin then returned to fumble 97 yards for a score 3 minutes later. Here's the call from Billy Morgan on the Harding Sports Network.
And now it's fourth and goal. From the one, empty backfield. From the one, they're gonna go. Snap it to Kleinpeter. Kleinpeter, he lost the football. It's scooped up and returned, picked up at the 3-yard line down the left sideline, and nobody is gonna catch Griffin. Midfield to the 40, to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Harding. Clark Griffin scooped it up and returns it 95-plus yards. We'll see what the official return on it is, but it's a scoop and score, and the Bisons with a quick turn right there and now lead it by 20.
Southeastern racked up 591 yards of total offense and got 5 touchdown passes from quarterback Dalton Hatley in a 62-14 win over Oklahoma Baptist. The Savage Storm led 42-0 at halftime thanks to a 35-point second quarter and eventually built that lead to 55-0. Hatley completed 81% of his passes and threw for 332 yards. Marquise Gray had 125 yards receiving and three touchdowns, and DeAndre Wheeler rushed for 106 yards and two touchdowns himself. Here's the first of Gray's three touchdown receptions from Jay Lindley on the Southeastern Sports Network.
Snap from the right hash on first and 10. Play action. Hatley goes right toward Gray, one-on-one, and a diving grab. Is it in? It is. Touchdown, Southeastern. Marquise Gray from 27 yards out. What does he do, Rob?
Catch touchdowns, Jade.
Make it back-to-back wins for Southern Nazarene for the first time since 2018 after a 27-21 win over Northwestern Oklahoma State. With the game tied at 21 early in the fourth quarter, Southern Nazarene quarterback Gage Porter rushed for his third touchdown of the day on a 21-yard run with 10:38 left to play. The teams went back and forth the majority of the fourth quarter before Northwestern had a chance to tie and take the lead with a first-and-goal situation. Southern Nazarene forced an incompletion on fourth-and-goal from the 5 to secure the win. Here's that call from Sean Thurman.
So now three wides on the right. He's looking to the right. He throws over the middle, and it's broken up! It was in the hands of Torrance Stevens. They had the look that they wanted, but the SNU step in secondary steps up and breaks up the pass and will take over with 1:45 left to play.
Henderson State moved to 6-2 with a 35-19 win over Arkansas Tech in the 98th meeting between the teams, thanks to a strong third quarter and the quarterback-receiver connection of Andrew Edwards and Xavier Malone. The Reddies led 21-13 at halftime before Edwards and Malone connected twice in the third quarter to stretch the Reddy lead to 35-13. Edwards passed for 302 yards on the day, 207 of which went to Malone. The second scoring strike between Edwards and Malone, an 80-yard pass on the first play of the drive, provided the last score of the day for the Reddies. Here's Blake Smith with that call on the Reddy Sports Network.
Little play fake. Edwards goes to the air. Malone one-on-one in stride. Gone. 40, 30, and Malone takes his time, and he'll stroll into the end zone. Touchdown, Reddies. 80 yards, Edwards to Malone.
This week in the GAC, we have one Thursday night game as East Central travels to Ouachita for a 6 p.m. kickoff. On Saturday, there will be four games kicking off at 2 p.m., including Southern Arkansas at Oklahoma Baptist, Southwestern Oklahoma State at Arkansas Tech, Southeastern Oklahoma State at Arkansas Monticello, and Henderson State at Southern Nazarene. Harding hosts Northwestern Oklahoma State in the only 3 p.m. kickoff of the day. This has been the Week 8 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help. To be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
Our town, a place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch, a place to sit back and watch the world go by, a place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Today is Senior Day, and we want to take time now to recognize an outstanding class of Tiger football seniors, 18 student-athletes who have distinguished themselves both on the field and in the classroom, and along the way have led Ouachita to three conference championships, a 48-4 overall conference record since 2017, an historic 14th consecutive winning season, and a first-place ranking in the current Great American Conference standings. Let's meet the Tiger football class of 2022. We start with number one, linebacker Ty Compton. A sports administration major from Pine Bluff, Arkansas, Ty has played in 28 games in his Ouachita career and started in 22. In that time, he has accumulated 88 tackles, 4.5 tackles for loss, 2 sacks, 6 pass breakups, and 1 forced fumble. He has been named Ouachita Defensive Player of the Week and played on the 2018 and 2019 GAC Championship teams. Ty is escorted tonight by his parents, Nikki Manning and Ty Compton Sr. Next, number 15, running back T.J. Cole! A kinesiology major from Texarkana, Texas, T.J. has played in 37 career games as a Ouachita Tiger. He has over 3,500 rushing yards and 41 touchdowns with additional games yet to play. He has 19 career receptions and 246 receiving yards, and he has 4 career passing attempts for 41 yards and a touchdown. In 2021, T.J. was honored with several postseason accolades, including the AFCA All-American First Team, the D2 Football Elite 100 All-America Second Team, and the Don Hanson Football Committee All-America Honorable Mention. He was also named Ouachita's Outstanding Male Athlete for 2021. T.J. currently enjoys the number 1 or number 2 ranked nationally in all rushing statistical categories and is at present on the watch list for the Harlan Hill Trophy, the Division II equivalent of the Heisman. TJ is escorted tonight by his mother, Regina Cole, and his father, Tony Cole Sr. Next, number 16, quarterback Grant Allen. An accounting and finance double major from Springdale, Arkansas, Grant was an 11-game starter at quarterback for the Tigers in 2021, leading the Tigers to a 9-2 season, including a Battle of the Ravine victory over Henderson State University. He was also named Ouachita Offensive Player of the Week. Grant has appeared in over 20 games for the Tigers, throwing for 1,000 yards passing and rushing for 300 yards while scoring 5 touchdowns. In the classroom, Grant has been named to the Ouachita Dean's List 3 times and once to the President's List. Grant is escorted tonight by his parents, Michelle and Jason Allen, and his sister, Olivia Allen. Next, number 18, tight end, Hunter Swoboda. A finance and political science double major from Bentonville, Hunter has started 32 games as a Ouachita Tiger and appeared in 37 games in his career. He has 14 receptions for 274 yards and 3 touchdowns, and he has earned all-conference honors twice. Hunter has been named to the Dean's List 6 times and has twice been named Academic All-Conference. Hunter is escorted tonight by his parents, Betsy and Brandon Swoboda. Next up, number 19, wide receiver Justin Dean. A management and marketing double major from Mena, Arkansas, Justin has played in 37 career games for Ouachita with over 20 receptions for 402 receiving yards and 4 touchdowns. Justin has also been a force on special teams, where he made 21 total tackles and returned 15 kickoffs for 225 yards. Justin was named special teams captain by his teammates this season, and he will be remembered for his selflessness and his humility. Justin is escorted tonight by his parents, Janet and Matt Dean. Our next senior, number 20, linebacker Tommy Crumpton III. A sports administration major from College Station, Arkansas, Tommy has played in 44 games in his Ouachita career. He has 50 career tackles, 5 tackles for loss, 1.5 sacks, and 1 interception. He has been named Ouachita Defensive Player of the Week twice and played on the 2018 and 2019 GAC Championship teams. Tommy is escorted tonight by his family, Lakem Crumpton, Deontay Gordon, and Edith Gordon. Our next senior, number 22, defensive back Jason Jackson Jr. A business major with an emphasis in finance from DeKalb, Texas, Jason has played in 16 games for the Tigers and lettered in 2021. A team leader on the field, in the locker room, and in the classroom, Jason has 9 tackles in his 2-year career at Ouachita and snared his first career interception earlier this month in the Tigers' victory against Southwestern Oklahoma State University. Jason is escorted tonight by his mother, Kelly Proby, and his girlfriend, Riley Horton. Next up, number 35, linebacker Josh Wallace. An engineering physics major from Arkadelphia, Josh has appeared in 8 games for the Tigers with 4 solo and 6 assisted tackles. Josh lettered in 2021 and was also named Academic All-Conference. He is a member of the Men of Beta Beta, for whom he has served as pledge master. He was named a Tiger Scholar every semester at Ouachita, and he has been on the Dean's List 5 times. Josh is escorted tonight by his parents, Molly and Brent Wallace, and other extended family. Our next senior, graduate student number 38, linebacker Anthony Terrell Gibson. A 2021 cum laude graduate and current candidate for a master's degree in curriculum and instruction from Junction City, Arkansas, Terrell has played in 30 games and started 22 throughout his Ouachita career. He has 125 career tackles. This season so far, he has 39 tackles, including 3 tackles for loss, 2 pass breakups, and a fumble recovery. He was selected this year as a team captain, and he is a leader on the Ouachita defense. Terrell is escorted tonight by his parents, Katina and Anthony Gibson. Our next senior, number 46, specialist Trey Flint. A management major from Grapevine, Texas, Trey will make his 20th career start tonight as long snapper for Ouachita football. In his career, he has recorded 2 tackles and 2 fumble recoveries, and his best memory of playing at Ouachita was snapping the game-winning ball in the 2021 Battle of the Ravine. Trey has been named to the Dean's List. He has been a Ouachita Tiger Scholar every semester throughout his career and plans to pursue an MBA upon graduation. Trey is escorted tonight by his parents, Sherry and Chuck Flint. Our next senior, number 48, defensive lineman Anthony Freeman. A kinesiology pre-professional studies major from Monroe, Louisiana. Anthony has been a 2-year starter and appeared in 44 games as a defensive end for Ouachita. He has 105 career tackles, 24 and a half tackles for loss, and 13 sacks. Last year, Anthony earned first-team All-Conference and second-team All-Region honors, and he earned academic All-Conference honors in 2019 and 2021. Anthony has been named to the Ouachita Dean's List 4 times. Anthony is escorted tonight by his mother, Alicia Freeman, sister, Kiera Freeman, brothers, Xavier Freeman, Armiel Bell, and Goliath Norman, and his girlfriend, Maya Jackson. Our next graduate student and senior, number 61, offensive lineman, Hunter Jackson. A 2022 graduate and current candidate for a master's degree in curriculum and instruction from Ozark, Arkansas. Hunter has been a rock for the Tiger offensive line at the right guard position for 44 games in his career. In that time, the Tigers have averaged 37 points per game and have rushed for an average of 286 yards per game. Hunter earned All-Conference honors in 2021 and has been named twice to the Ouachita Dean's and President's lists. Hunter is escorted tonight by his parents, Tracy and Kevin Jackson, his brothers Colton and Lawson Jackson, his sister-in-law Jordan Jackson, nephew Noah Jackson, and his grandparents, Donna and Kelly Jackson, and Mary and Roger Sanders. Next, number 65, offensive lineman Clayton Nelson. A finance major from Crossett, Arkansas, Clayton has started 3 games and participated in 21 since coming to Ouachita in the spring 2020 from the United States Naval Academy. He has been an integral part of the Ouachita offensive short yardage game plans and rotates snaps with other members of the O-line at the guard position. Academically, he has been named to the Ouachita Dean's List. Clayton is escorted tonight by his mother, Reagan Murphy, his stepfather, Bradley Murphy, and his sister, Maddie Murphy. Next up, number 68, offensive lineman Peyton Stafford. A finance, marketing, and entrepreneurship triple major from Amarillo, Texas. Peyton has started 32 games at left guard for Ouachita and appeared in 39 games overall. He was voted team captain for the 2021 and 22 seasons and last year earned first-team All-Conference, first-team All-Region, and D2CCA and Don Hansen All-American honors. He has been named to the Dean's List 9 times, once to the President's List, and he has earned academic All-Conference honors twice. He is currently a finalist for the prestigious William V. Campbell Trophy, known as the Academic Heisman, and awarded to the college football player with the best combination of academics, community service, and on-field performance. Peyton is escorted this evening by his parents, Lee and Joe Stafford, and his grandparents, Mary Beth and Cliff Garrison. Our next senior, number 70, offensive lineman Jax Gassaway. An entrepreneurship major from Star City, Arkansas, Jax has participated in 15 games for Ouachita and started three over a three-year career. His season was cut short this year by injury in the Tigers' victory over Harding, but not before earning a 92% game grade for his performance. Jax has played both guard and tackle in his time on the offensive line and has been named to the Ouachita Dean's List. Jax is escorted tonight by his mother, Lisa Brown, stepfather, Bobby Brown, father, Greg Gassaway, and stepmother, Kelly Howard. Our next senior, number 75, offensive lineman Anthony Chavez. A sports management major from Sherwood, Arkansas, Anthony has been a three-year starter at right tackle for Ouachita and has appeared in 36 games. He has been a vital part of an offense that has averaged 421 yards per game and an offensive line that has averaged only 0.4 sacks per game. The Tigers' winning percentage throughout Anthony's career has been 91%. Anthony has earned all-conference honors twice and all-region honors once. Anthony is escorted today by his parents, Candine and Frank Chavez, his brother, Jordan Chavez, and his grandmother, Kathy Christensen. Our next senior, number 53, place kicker, Mason Martin. A biology major from Cabot, Arkansas, Mason has been a leader both on the field and in the classroom for the K unit. He is a two-time member of the Great American Conference All-Academic Team. He is escorted this evening by his parents, Todd and Elizabeth Martin. Our final senior this evening, number 96, defensive lineman, Clark Yarborough Jr. A business administration sports management major from Rowlett, Texas. Clark was a two-year starter for the Tigers at defensive tackle and appeared in 20 games. Throughout his career, he accumulated 36 tackles and 3.5 tackles for loss. He earned all-conference honorable mention honors in 2021. Clark passed from this life on September 4th, but left an indelible mark on the Ouachita community and the people who knew him. Clark served as a resident assistant for 3 years, and he is remembered on campus as a humble servant leader. He was an exemplary student, academically, athletically, and spiritually. His deep Christian faith was evident in the way he lived his life. He was a positive influence on everyone around him, and while he was a quiet man, when Clark Yarborough spoke, his words carried meaning and weight. Clark led Bible study with students from both Ouachita and Henderson State, and he was an inspiring mentor to his teammates. He will always be missed. He will always be remembered. Representing Clark tonight are his mother, Maddie Yarborough, his brothers, Matthew and Alan Yarborough, and his father, Clark Yarborough Sr. Let's hear it one more time for your 2022 Tiger Football Senior Class.
Hello and welcome back to the OSDN pregame show presented by Captain Henderson House. I'm Chase Hartzell, joined by Chris Gay. And Chris, it's hard to believe it, but senior night is here. It's a Thursday night game at Cliff Harris Stadium, and it's a battle of the Tigers, East Central taking on Ouachita Baptist.
Yeah, it's going to be a great matchup. I mean, you have East Central, they're on the rise. I mean, this is a team that they haven't had a lot of success in the last few years, but this season, after having an 0-2 start to the year, they've won their last six games. And this is a team that they can do a little bit of everything. They can pass. Hearn Sear is just a great quarterback. He's getting close. He's over 1,900 yards, which is third most in the conference right now. And then Harad has over 800 rushing yards. You know, they're a team that they are a running team. They have T.J. Cole up over 1,000, actually up over 1,200 yards, and then Kendall Givens at 800 yards. So it's going to be an interesting but a great offensive matchup.
I couldn't agree more, Chris. And it's worth mentioning, too, that right now East Central is on the second longest win streak in the Great American Conference. So they are now firmly in second place. That longest win streak, of course, belonging to the Tigers because they are undefeated this year. And a big part of that attack, you mentioned the offensive attack, has been T.J. Cole. And one of the big stories coming into this game is that Cole's looking at a lot of history going into this game here tonight. First off, looking back at last week against SAU, a history-making performance as Ouachita scores 63 points yet again. It's the first time in school history that Ouachita scores at least 63 points in three different games over the course of a season. But for T.J. Cole scoring a school record six rushing touchdowns, it was a great day for him on the ground, adding 230 yards as well. He's now a back-to-back GAC Player of the Week, and he's got a couple of different records that he's looking at now. You got that school record behind you for the single-game touchdown record, but he's also creeping up on the school's career rushing touchdown record. He currently has 41. The record is 43. We could see him tie and even potentially break it here tonight. And also looking at his season stats, too, he's got 1,270 yards going into this game, just 30 yards away from becoming the first player in Ouachita history to rush for 1,300 yards in a season two different times in his career.
Yeah, that's a guy that he's going to go down in the record books for being a great Tiger. But not only that, but he's going to go down in the record books for being one of the best running backs we've seen coming out of the Great American Conference. Could even make an argument, maybe one of the better ones in this century out of Division II. So he's had a great year, but he's not the only guy. And this is a team, they average 48 points per game. East Central, they have a great offense, but they're averaging only 30 points per game. And I know they've kind of had to play, they've had a lot of close games. Ouachita has been blowing teams out left and right. This is, again, a great offense, and it's really behind guys like Cole, guys like Kendall Givens, and then even guys in our receiving core like Justin Dean and Connor Flanagan, who just had amazing years.
And for East Central, you look at that game too. They've had some good wins this year too. One of the big ones being against Henderson State, won that one 31-10, a convincing victory over the Reddies, who are right there in the mix for second place as well in the Great American Conference. And that's made even more impressive when you look at Henderson's more recent victories, including that one over Harding, who was number 12 at the time, held the Bisons to just two scores in that game. But the Tigers had great success against Henderson State. They've been having some solid success as well. You mentioned they're not one of the top scoring offenses, but their defense has also been keeping them in games and getting them to win. So a lot of different ways that you can work at that. You mentioned Kendall Givens for Ouachita, a chance for the first time in a long time for Ouachita to have two 1,000-yard rushers, something that not a lot of teams can say at any classification. And on top of that, too, Ouachita has really seen a renaissance in the passing game this year, too, with Riley Harms. Riley Harms has found a lot of connections with Connor Flanagan, another senior that's in the mix, too, is Justin Dean. He's been a playmaker who's been making a lot of plays. He's been done well on the sweep. He's gotten open on several routes. He's scored a touchdown or two himself, and it's really been a great campaign for the senior. But one group that we really haven't mentioned yet is really the unit that kind of holds it all together, the team that's providing the protection for the quarterback, for the running back, and really allowing for those opportunities downfield for the wide receivers to get open, and that's the offensive line. Ouachita's got a lot of seniors on that offensive line, and this unit is widely considered one of the best in the country.
Yeah, I don't blame you. Riley Harms has had, he's had a career year without a doubt, and it's behind guys like Peyton Stafford and Hunter Jackson and Jerez. It's just a great group of linemen, and yeah, you got to give the big boys some love. And That doesn't happen nearly as much as it should have, but I, you know, it's great that they're getting some recognition throughout the conference, because I truly do believe this is probably the best offensive line in the conference. They may not have to hold, they may not have to do a lot of pass blocking snaps, but they do have to create a lot of holes. T.J. Cole's not just going on the outside every time. He's running up the middle. So is Kendall Givens. We're a great red zone team. We have 39 red zone touchdowns this year. And you don't do that if your offensive line is not solid like they have been thus far.
Yes, and a couple more seniors to mention. Clayton Nelson, another key contributor on the offensive line this season. Jax Gassaway has also been a huge part of the offensive line in recent years. He's suffered from injuries a little bit this year, but still contributing to the team in a big way. And another guy that we haven't talked about yet, you think about him more in the receiving game in previous years, but he's really contributed to blocking in the run game as well throughout his career at Ouachita, and that's Hunter Swoboda.
Yeah, he's definitely, he's a tight end. He doesn't get a lot of catches, and that's fine because he's blocking, and he's essentially a sixth offensive lineman. That's really what he is, and he's so valuable to that team. That, and of course, he's versatile. He's going to go out and he can get you a catch. He can go and get you a red zone touchdown if you absolutely need it. But he's very versatile. But he's definitely a guy that's one of those pass blocking or those blocking tight ends that doesn't get a lot of glory, but they're so valuable to the success of an offense.
And now flipping on to the other side of things, you have the defense. And, of course, one of the big stories going into senior night, of course, is Clark Yarbrough will be recognized. Of course, Clark passed away earlier in the year. Tough loss for the team. But really, we've seen the team rally around and really come together as a result of that event. And they've been paying tribute to Clark in the best way that possible, and that's with consistent play across the defensive front, in the secondary, with the linebackers. It seems that everybody's locked in, perhaps even more than we've ever seen them. You look at the last several weeks, Ouachita has been winning games by more than 30 points every time out since the Harding game. And that was one where the defense really did lead you to victory, because they were setting up the opportunities for the offense to try and score, but also they were containing one of the most electric run games in the nation as well, in the form of the Bison's offense. They like to run that option, and they were able to contain after a few slip-ups early in the game, locked down in the second half, didn't allow any points. And really this year, you look at the first eight games, only three times have teams scored 24 points or more, that including the first game of the season where you're still ironing out some of the details. In those other two games, Southwestern Oklahoma State is one of the teams that scored 24, and that is a very electric offense that has really benefited this year from a bit of a turnaround, got some new personnel in there, and they've been working very well, having a comeback year in their own right there. But then on top of that, too, you also have last week's game against SAU, and they've really seen a renaissance as well on the offensive side of the ball under Brad Smiley. But you look across the board at Ouachita's defensive performance, it's been consistent all the way through. The Tigers are providing opportunities for the offense, and they're making sure that no matter what game it is, Ouachita's in there, and they've really allowed the offense to pull away with some big victories this year.
Well, one of the keys to the Tigers is that the Ouachita Tigers, that is, their job is to keep the defense off the field. And they do a great job of that. They have a great run game. They kind of run out that clock, but they still put a lot of points up on the board. But regardless, that defense, it doesn't matter if your offense is not clicking. That defense is solid. Guys like Miller and Anthony Freeman and Burks and Terrell Gibson, that's a great defense. And defensive line, linebacker core, secondary, you know, this is a team that holds opponents to only about 16 points a game. And this is going to be an interesting game, because Ouachita has not seen a lot of quarterbacks that pass a lot. We've seen mostly running teams, and we've shown that we can stop the run. But the question is, can we stop both? We haven't really seen a team that has that consistent threat of both in the rushing attack and in the passing attack. Now, for the East Central Tigers, they have a solid defense, but it's not anything that's going to blow teams away. Guys like Devon Roche is going to be extremely valuable. He's got 70 tackles on the year, and he's probably going to have more tackles in this game. He's going to be a tackling machine, and that's a guy that Ouachita is going to look at. You know, Riley Harms is going to call out his number every time he sees him on the field. You know, look at him. So he's so dangerous for that defense.
It's going to be a fun matchup to watch. A lot to celebrate this year in Ada, Oklahoma, if you're a fan of the East Central Tigers. Going on a nice win streak here, but now a big challenge on the road facing the number four Ouachita Tigers. And for Ouachita, trying to keep that win streak alive, as you mentioned, Chris, trying to combat that balanced attack, one that Ouachita really hasn't seen too much this season in the GAC. But it's going to be a good challenge for the Tigers here on senior night in front of a good home crowd.
Yeah, and one last thing about that. Tigers, Ouachita have won the last eight matchups against this team, and since all the way back to 2012. So if you're East Central, this is the year to win. This is, you know, maybe your team isn't as talented, isn't as stacked, doesn't have as much depth as Ouachita does, but this is the time to win. This is the time to really show fans, hey, this is a team that can really compete with the best at the conference and can even get some respect on the national level. But this is their chance, and if they can't pull it off, then, you know, it's going to be the ninth straight victory Ouachita has against East Central.
It's going to be a good challenge for both teams as they start to get into the final stretch here of Great American Conference play. And for Ouachita, this is an important game because if the Tigers win tonight, Ouachita will at least have a share, they'll clinch a share of the Great American Conference title because they already have that two-game lead going into the next couple weeks. But not only that, you set yourself an opportunity in Durant, Oklahoma, to claim the outright conference championship there with a victory. Really good opportunity for the Tigers, especially when you start to look at the postseason now starting to shape up in terms of seeding for the national playoffs. Ouachita trying to stay undefeated and get that home game in the postseason should be a pretty exciting atmosphere. Of course, tonight being senior night, but you're playing for that one extra game. You always want to play that one extra game in front of the home fans. And tonight the Tigers have a rare opportunity to try and continue that pursuit for that exact opportunity in question.
Well, and this is when seniors are at their best because they have the experience. Even if they haven't had a lot of game experience, this is a group that, especially Ouachita's group of seniors, they have, like I said, they have experience, but they know how to control the locker room. They have the chemistry. This is a team that we have. Ouachita's got a lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomores that run the offense, run the defense, but this is when the seniors are at their most important.
Well, we are just moments away from kickoff, and we'll be back with just a little bit more of the pregame show and here in just a few moments, wrapping up some of the last festivities as the seniors get ready to celebrate a huge night, hopefully, here at Ouachita Baptist University. But Chris, thank you for joining me, and we'll be back with more Tiger football here in just a few moments.
They only scored 12 points in their first game, 13 points in the second game. But since then, been on a roll. They won winning 44-21, won 31-3, 34-22, 31-10, 34-20, and 42-28. So the defense has cranked in, or the offense has cranked in gear, and the defense has been playing well. Really the top in the conference scoring defense other than Ouachita. Ouachita has the top scoring defense, ECU at number two. So this is a team that after the first 2 weeks really found its footing and presents a tough test for Ouachita tonight and really a tough test for both teams, Dr. Rudas. This is a Thursday night game. They didn't have a whole lot of time to prepare for each other, and this is one of the bigger matchups in the GAC this year.
Ouachita will receive, and we're set for the kickoff. So let's go to the voice of the Tigers, Rex Nelson.
Thank you, Dr. Jeff Root. Alexis Lopez will kick off. It is going to be a fairly short kick that's going to be taken at the 13, brought up over the 20, up over the 25 to the 27-yard line by Justin Dean, and that's where Ouachita will go to work. First down and 10. Now, they ended up winning both games easily, Richard, but let's not forget Ouachita has fallen behind early in each of the previous two football games.
They have. Well, they're going to have the ball here first, so they're going to have a chance to go down and take a lead, but the one thing this ECU defense does is turn teams over. Number one turnover margin in the country. So the Tigers are going to have to protect the ball today.
Riley Harms, the quarterback, the All-American T.J. Cole will get the give. Cole right up the middle. He's going to be hit at the 30-yard line after a gain of three. My goodness, Jeff, what a game last week for T.J. Cole. 230 yards, six touchdowns on the ground, the Division II National Offensive Player of the Week.
He ran through some great holes created by the offensive line and the wide receivers. He also made some holes by running through defenders. What a week it was for Cole.
Second down and seven, going to pass out into the flats. Connor Flanagan, somebody missed a block out there, and he's going to lose a yard back to the 29. So Richard going to bring up a quick passing situation with Wichita facing a third and eight.
Yeah, Tucker Sobota just didn't do a good job enough out there on the edge blocking. ECU saw what was coming. Lots of times they're going to see that play coming, but if you block it well, you're still going to be able to get some yards. Nothing there. And on third down, Wichita, you're right, going to be in a passing situation here.
Tigers moving from the near hash mark, moving right to left in this first quarter. Black jerseys tonight and black pants with the purple numerals and purple helmets. Riley Harms out of the shotgun, straight drop back. Has time, can't find anybody open. Now's going to run for it, up over the 35 and a first down. Riley Harms is so good, Jeff, at knowing exactly how much he needs. He needed to get to the 37. He got to the 38. New set of downs.
He broke a tackle also. A defender had him by the ankle. It looked like he'd bring him down. He just ran through it. And then those long strides got him first down yardage.
First down and 10, Wichita working from the middle of the field, moving right to left. No score, just underway at Cliff Harris Stadium on our second Thursday night game of the year. T.J. Cole set to the left of his quarterback. He gets the pitch this time. Again, a missed block out there, Richard, and a very hard hit put on by Donovan Callis at the 41 after a gain of three.
Yeah, he's the same player that made the tackle on Connor Flanagan a minute ago. So that is a cornerback that does not mind getting up and tackling, because that was a big-time tackle he had on T.J. Cole that time. Still a little bit of a gain. Unusual to see Wichita with the pitch there. A little surprise there, but they're trying to catch ECU off guard.
Yep, used to seeing the straight handoff to TJ. Instead, it was the pitch left. Now Cole sets up to the right of his quarterback as they come out of the shotgun on second down. They are going to be passing right side. Got a receiver out over the 50 to the 48-yard line. That's going to be a first down for Wichita. Coming up with it, Chris Hightower, the sophomore transfer from Central Arkansas.
Hightower just checked into the game because Tucker Swoboda was hurt on the previous play. He's limping on the sideline, still walking around trying to get out of that limp. But what a play by Hightower just into the game.
And a great pass by Harms. Now they come out of the pistol, go to T.J. Cole, over left tackle to the 45-yard line. Second down and seven, and quickly Richard Wichita has moved into ECU territory.
Yeah, really without T.J. Cole having much of a big run, East Central so far is bottling up the holes. Of course, Wichita is going to keep leaning on them and count on those to open a little bit more, and they're actually going to go with a direct snap here as Edwards comes into the ballgame. He'll line up next to T.J. Cole, who will be lined up to take that direct snap.
Yeah, Isaac Edwards will set to the right of T.J. Cole, so the senior will get the direct snap with two wide receivers to his left. Cole looking for a hole, can't find much of one. Down at the 45, that's no gain, Jeff, and it's going to bring up another passing situation for Wichita, third and seven.
That might be the best defensive work we've seen all season against the direct snap. Usually Cole is able to take a moment, find a hole, and sprint through it. That time, there wasn't anywhere to run.
This is a very confident East Central team coming in tonight after six consecutive victories. Wichita, eight consecutive. East Central, six consecutive. So the biggest game of the year so far in the GAC. Harm sets up, has time, got a receiver at the 25-yard line. Ball comes out, and it's going to be recovered by East Central. Had a first down deep, and the first turnover is going to go to East Central University trying to make the cut. The ball came out, and recovering it for East Central Oklahoma, Keontae Lusk.
We talked about it. This is a very opportunistic defense, and Connor Flanagan went to spin, and as he came out of the spin, they punched the football out of there. Sometimes when you spin, that ball does not stay as tight to you as you would running forward. And East Central smartly pokes it out, and they're able to recover it. And that's what they have done all year. That's how they've gotten on this six-game win streak.
Like you said, they lead in turnover margin, and there you go. They're already plus one. They will give on the ground to start the football game. Good running room out over the 25, out to the 27-yard line goes East Central's Niemeyer Herod. So Niemeyer Herod moves the chains immediately, Jeff. That's a quick 10 yards.
Well, that was a shoestring tackler. He might have gone for a touchdown. Really good sprint to the left side. They're looking very strong early on.
Herod, as they work from the 28, is where they'll spot it. So call it officially an 11-yard gain on their first play from scrimmage. East Central moving left to right. Wichita and completed a pass deep, but they turned it over. Pass out into the left flats, running room again, out over the 35 to the 36-yard line. This time, that's Greg Howe, a senior, a transfer from Tyler Junior College. And they're going no huddle, which gave Tigers problems early last week, Richard.
Well, the first drive is what gives the Tigers the most trouble really this year. We've seen several times where the team has gone out and scored on the first drive and then really has not scored a touchdown the rest of the game. And so that's kind of been what's hurt the Tigers, if they, you can say, one Achilles heel on the defense so far.
Second and two, looking to pass. Hernser going left side and got a receiver at the 43-yard line. Bringing it in is Greg Hound. It's another first down, Jeff. And quickly, East Central has moved the chains twice on this possession.
He made a nice cut to the sideline and was wide open. Had to dive to catch the ball, or he might have had more yardage.
First down and 10, East Central, no score. 9:20 is what we have remaining in the first quarter. We're familiar with this quarterback, Kenny Hernser. He has started against the Tigers the last two times they have played East Central. Hernser this time will hand off, and nothing doing that time. Nothing there. And it's going to be second and long. Good job of the defense that time, Richard.
Jerelyn Burks in there on the tackle. The defensive tackle was back there very quickly, and that's what they needed, a first down negative yardage. But Kenny Hernser, the passer, or the quarterback, is a great passer. He's also a really good runner, Rex. He only has 130 yards on the ground, but he is a very mobile quarterback, so it's something you have to pay attention to. Doesn't want to run, but very capable. And in past years, we've seen him run a whole lot more than he has this year.
He'll be passing this time because he's got an empty backfield. Second and 11 for East Central. Hernser, straight drop. Has time, looking, going deep this time, and it is dropped. Pretty good double coverage down there by Ouachita, though, Jeff. Intended receiver was Jackson Allen. He's a big tight end, a transfer from Texas A&M Commerce.
He's big, and he got a hand on it but couldn't pull it in. I think he saw a safety coming, and Ouachita has forced him into a fourth and long, but that was a scary play, almost a long completion.
Yeah, third and long, actually. Third down and 11 from the 42-yard line. So we'll see if the Tiger defense can get a stop here. Two men to the near side, two men to the far side for East Central. Big play, third and 11, East Central, Oklahoma. Straight drop back, Hernser forced out of the pocket, gets a one down there, and it's incomplete. Too short, got some pressure on him, and I think that made him pass a little more quickly than he wanted to, Richard, and he could not get it to his tight end, Talik Jackson, who was all the way down at the Ouachita 23.
Yeah, ball a little underthrown. There was some hand fighting, but it was from both of them, and he may have, the receiver may have been out of bounds, too. No flag thrown as it was kind of mutual contact there. Connor Flanagan, who fumbled on the reception a minute ago, is back to return the punt.
And I'm sure he's going to want to make up for that. So we'll see if he can get a return here as Reese Connor will punt the football away for East Central. Going to be a fair catch as it's a nice high punt at the 21. So first down and 10, Ouachita will go to work from the 21-yard line. No score, 8 minutes and 13 seconds is what we have remaining in the first quarter. Media timeout on the field, so we will pause. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
Zero, East Central, Oklahoma, zero. Ouachita turned it over during a drive, and then East Central made two first downs and turned it over with a punt. Ouachita will have the ball back momentarily.
And so East Central leads the turnover battle early, Richard, 1-0, but Ouachita's defense does its job after bending just a little bit, so no score in the football game.
Well, that's the 14th fumble recovery for ECU through Wow. I mean, part of the year, you're not even done. This is the ninth game that had 14 fumble recoveries. That's impressive.
And very impressive. First down and 10. Let's see if this offense can get moving again. Coming out of the pistol, T.J. Cole will get the call. He runs into a wall and nothing there. Boy, they are doing a nice job on Cole so far, Jeff. Second and 10 from the 21.
Yeah, they're certainly playing to stop Cole, and they've been able to do it so far. Wichita's thrown successfully late in mostly third down. Maybe on second down they'll put it back in the air this time.
Yeah, you're going to have to loosen them up a little bit because they are loading up in the middle to stop the All-American T.J. Cole. So Tigers will come out of the shotgun. Riley Harms looking to pass. Got a receiver across the middle, wide open at the 50, 45, 40, 35, 30. Trying to break a tackle all the way down to the 20-yard line. T.J. Cole, we're used to seeing him on big runs. We saw him that time on a big pass reception.
Yeah, just snuck out of the backfield. You could tell very, very quickly. He had a step on the linebacker that was trying to cover him. They kind of dropped in a bit of a zone, and the linebacker was never going to be able to stay with him there. And that was a great job, good pass, and Cole with a big gainer. That's how you loosen up a little bit when you're trying to stop that run. Hit a big pass.
First down and 10. Ball at the 20-yard line of East Central. No score. Washchild trying to punch it in, though. Cole on the direct snap. Big hole this time. 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Milk. Honey, touchdown, T.J. Cole, touchdown, Washington.
You got to give credit to Brock Howard there, the fullback, lined up on the left side of the scrimmage, and basically it was like a pulling guard coming through the hole, took the linebacker out of the play and just really freed up everything. Great job by Howard. It would have been a five-yard gain, but Howard kicked that man out, and T.J. Cole's able to go into the end zone for the touchdown.
All right, it was a quick 79-yard drive, Dr. Root. Extra point is up and good by Dax Jaggers.
Dax Jaggers did a perfect job last week, 9 for 9, 1 for 1 so far tonight, and Wichita grabs the lead.
7:01 left to go, first quarter. Wichita 7, East Central Oklahoma nothing. Wichita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
A three-play, 79-yard drive for Wichita, led by Cole, who caught a pass for 60, then ran for 20. Wichita leads it 7-0, 7:01 left in the first quarter.
Boy, that was a lightning drive right there, Richard.
And with that touchdown, T.J. Cole ties William Miller for number 2 all-time in rushing touchdowns with 42. Of course, William Miller here, 75 through 78.
William Miller,
the great one. Heck of a career for both of them.
Yep, 1978. I tell the story again. William Miller led the way. The first Washington football game I ever called play-by-play on, Jeff.
He had a great college career and then was the Rookie of the Year in the Canadian Football League.
Yep, absolutely. Good memory. Rookie of the Year in 79 in the Canadian Football League. All right, here is the kickoff. It will be Jaggers kicking it off for Washington. Taken at the 2, so it will be returned, and good coverage down there by the Tigers. They will bring it only out to the 20-yard line. And so first down and 10, and Hernser and company will come back onto the field. Hernser is a pretty talented quarterback. I think the key tonight is going to be getting pressure on him and forcing him, Jeff, to rush those passes.
I think you're exactly right. They don't turn the ball over often. They've won a lot of close games, and they have been able to score in more recent games a larger number of points. So they've got some talent offensively, but this is tough defense, obviously, for Wichita.
Hernser is going to give to Harrod. He's coming left side this time and is going to have 5, maybe even 6. Now they'll say – 7 yards up to the 27. Nice gain on first down, Richard.
It was, and they've had some good rushes so far on first down. And Rex, the fun thing about college football in Arkadelphia is Henderson State's across the street and just saw a few of their players walk in the game as they're going to scout Wichita and see a little game. It's kind of fun when you got the team across the street to come
Absolutely.
Watch.
Absolutely. Miles Davis is the running back now. Also a pretty good musician back in the day. Here is the give to Davis, and nothing there that time. Nothing to toot his horn about, Jeff. He's going to be a yard short, and it's going to be third and one.
Yeah, I think he forgot his music on that play. Just got a short gain. Third down coming.
I saw the Miles Davis once in concert back in Washington, D.C. in the 1980s. One of the great concerts I've ever seen. All right, big play. Back to football. Enough music. Enough music for now. Hernser with Davis set to his left. Third and one. Tigers trying to get the stop, leading 7-0 with 5:43 left to go in the first quarter, a Thursday night game at Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia. Hernser's going to pass on third and short. Forced out of the pocket, rolling to his left. Now he's going to try to run for it, and he's going to get there. Good second effort by Hernser. It appeared initially Richard Wichita had him stop, but he reached the football out knowing how much he needed for the first down.
Yeah, if you went by the knee, he was going to be short, but he was leaning forward with the football. It didn't look graceful, but he did enough to get the first down. We talked about it. He's not really trying to run as much this year, but he is a pretty good runner. You saw that time on the scramble. As Wichita got back there on the scramble to stop him, it was Dawson Miller, but unable to keep him from getting that first down.
He's out of Needville, Texas. He is a very talented athlete, Hernser is. Here's the give to Herrick coming left. Missed tackle. Not the second one, though. The first one was missed, and the second one was made, Jeff, by Wichita's Jackson McFarland.
Yeah, back there initially to him in the backfield was Gonzalez. There is a flag.
Dante Gibson. Good job by Gibson.
And there is a flag down right at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, it's going to be holding and moving back. But Gibson, great job on tackle. That's what you want to see from your safety there, Rex, is Gibson came flying up like a missile and didn't have to go for the knockout shot, just went and got him around the legs and brought him down. But it's not going to matter because it's going to go further back. And first and long now for East Central. Last time they were in a first and long situation, it was only first and 11 is when they ended up punting the football.
Yep, it's first and 20 now from the 20-yard line. So we'll see if Hernser will pass the football. His team trailing 7-0, clock moving. 4:50 left to go in the first quarter. Hernser with one running back, that is Herod, set to his right. Hernser is going to pass, comes across the middle of the field, got a receiver at the 30-yard line, forced out of bounds by Dante Gibson at the 31-yard line. Gain of 11, Jeff, it'll be second and nine.
That was a nice pass, a good run after the catch. It just basically gets back to where they started, though. So second and nine, and Wichita's defense is still in position for a stop.
Let's see if Hernser will be passing again. Wichita leading 7-0 late first quarter. Tigers of East Central come to the line of scrimmage, moving left to right, set on the near hash mark. Hernser now looks over to his sideline, apparently changing the play here with two wideouts to the left, one wideout to the right for East Central. Hernser, straight drop back, looking, in trouble, scrambling. He's coming right, breaks a tackle up over the 35-yard line before being forced out of bounds. On the near sideline, that's the Wichita sideline. Now they're going to put it right down on the 35. So, Jeff, it's going to bring up a big third and five play here.
Now, a passing situation, one would think. He never found anybody open that time, but escaped two tacklers in the backfield, got away from the sack, and got positive yardage. So even when you cover these guys, you got to watch the quarterback.
Yeah, Hernser's a big quarterback, and he can do some damage both on the ground and through the air. He'll be passing here, I would suspect. Rolling to his left. Now he throws too high, too hard. And again, credit Wichita with good pressure that time, Richard.
Well, first off, give credit to Anthony Freeman as they were trying to do a rolling pocket, but he wasn't able to roll as deep as he'd like. He had to get outside quick because Anthony Freeman was crashing the line. But then Jax Miller came through and absolutely wiped out Hernser on the pass, and that's why it went high. And so Wichita's made another stop on third down, and they're going to force a punt. Great job by Freeman and Miller that time.
So Connor Flanagan will be deep again for Wichita as Reese Connor is on for the second time tonight to punt for East Central. Wichita leading 7-0. Snap, kick very high, and it's going to be allowed to bounce. It will take an East Central bounce inside the 30 down to the 27, but Ouachita covered more yards than that their last possession, Jeff.
Well, it's just been hard for anybody to stop this Ouachita offense. They did a good job of coming to the line of scrimmage to stop Cole, so Cole just ran a pass pattern behind them and then ran for a touchdown on the keeper on the very next play, a three-play drive for a touchdown last time Ouachita had the ball.
Boy, beautiful sunset tonight on this Thursday night as I look to the west. Ouachita moving east to west. Here is the give, and boy, missed tackle there. Going to be a loss of yardage for Kendall Givens as Orlando Brown, the linebacker, was coming, and nobody picked him up, Richard.
Yeah, Orlando Brown, the inter-GAC transfer from southwest Oklahoma, now playing at East Central. And Givens is going to limp out of the ball game. Hope he's going to be okay. But the run game has been difficult for Ouachita. They did have the 20-yard touchdown for T.J. Cole. They've been doing it in the pass game so far today.
Second and 11 from the 26 after the one-yard loss. So Givens comes out of the game. T.J. Cole will come back in for Ouachita. Harms pointing in front of him, maybe changing the play. He's going to pass, and he just threw it away that time. Boy, the way Harms was pointing and looking around, that play just seemed discombobulated from the start, Richard.
Yeah, and we've seen a game or two this year where he's thrown the ball away and actually ended up throwing an interception because he didn't get enough air on it. He got enough air on that one, Rex.
Oh, yeah.
It went way out of there and lived to fight another down. But third and 11, not a spot where Ouachita finds themselves very often.
No, not a good start to this drive. Third down and 11 from the 26-yard line. Tigers moving right to left late first quarter. They set up on the far hash mark. Two receivers either side for Harms. Harms going to throw on the run. Diving catch made. They'll say trapped. Trapped, incomplete. So three and out for Ouachita, Jeff. Not a good look on offense that time.
Flanagan that time dove for the ball on the sideline, but could not hold it. Lost it as he hit the ground. And Ouachita will have to punt the ball away. If he had made the catch, would have been a first down.
Yep. Fourth down and 11. And Joe Couch, the Australian punter for Ouachita, will punt for the first time this evening. Couch set back at his 11-yard line, takes the snap. Good rush on. Couch gets a very nice one out of there, though. And it's going to take a Ouachita bounce. Another great job by Joe Couch as it goes out of bounds at the 25-yard line. So first down and 10 at the 25-yard line. Ouachita leading 7-0, but East Central hanging around, and I can see why they've won six straight. This is a pretty good-looking football team, Richard.
Yeah, it is, and right now we talked about it. They're selling out to stop the run, and they're doing it. We've seen teams do that against Ouachita, and they've not been able to do it. Now, there's still three quarters left to go in the game, so there's still a lot to do, but they have. And then offense, they've gotten a few first downs, so they bogged down kind of around that 40 to 45-yard line a couple times.
Kenny Hernser will come out of the pistol this time. Fakes to Herod, rolls to his right, looking to set up the screen, and he's got a receiver out there at the 25-yard line, out to the 28. He just took so much time, finally, that one of those big tight ends was able to get open. That was Josh Little, Jeff, and it'll be second down.
And he is not little. He made a nice catch near the sideline. Great job by the quarterback, though, to keep it alive, and then a good job by his receiver, Little, to come back for the ball.
Gain of three on the play, second and 7 from the 28. On second down, Hernser out of the shotgun again. Straight drop back, comes near side and threw it away on the Ouachita sideline. And we've got a flag down also, Richard.
It's going to be offsides on Ouachita.
All right, so he knew he had a free play there and went on and just threw it away when he saw he didn't have anybody open.
I think they actually stopped it before that because the offensive line for ECU moved. So at that point, you don't get the free play. It's a dead ball.
Okay, so second down and 2 then from the 33. Well, Ouachita mistake early on defense here. 7-0, Tigers lead. Late first quarter, a minute 30 left in the first quarter to be exact. Tigers of East Central moving left to right. They set on the near hash mark on second and short. One running back, that's Herod, set to the right of Hernser. Give Herod. Breaks one, breaks two tackles easily as the first down out to the 38. That's a gain of 5, Jeff. First down and 10. And East Central, as Richard mentioned, is piling up some first downs in this first quarter.
There have been series where they just looked unstoppable until they couldn't convert on a third down. Now they've got a first down again nearing midfield, made a first down already on this drive. They are piling them up, but Wichita still has the 7-0 lead.
First down and 10, ball at the 38-yard line. They set on the near hash mark in the final minutes of this third quarter. Hernser looking to go deep this time, right down the middle of the field and incomplete. Again, great coverage by Wichita. Intended receiver down there was Jaquan Lincoln, but there were black Wichita shirts everywhere down there, Richard.
Well, Jackson Miller, a linebacker, was running with him, and normally that's a mismatch when you get a linebacker running on a rhythm receiver, and he did a good job running with him. Might have been behind by just a step, but it didn't really matter when the ball was underthrown by about 5 yards.
Second down and 10 from the 38. We'll see if Hernser will pass again. They're going mostly to the air at this point in the football game. He's got trips to his left as they move left to right in the final seconds of the first quarter. Hernser going to keep it this time. Got a pretty good hole. Rolls off a Tiger out over the 45, out to the 46-yard line. That's a gain of 8 that's going to bring up a very important 3rd and 2, probably to start the second quarter, as we're down, well, we got 20 seconds, so this may be the last play here of the first quarter. Big play. 3rd down and short. Can the Tigers get the stop? Hernser with Herod set to his left. 10 seconds, 9 seconds, 8, 7. 6, 5. Are they going to get the snap off? They do. Hernser passing left side. Got a receiver, and he's got a first down and more into Wichita territory. And the Tigers of East Central are on the move as the first quarter comes to an end. It's Wichita 7, East Central Oklahoma nothing. Wichita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Arid Stadium in Arkadelphia in 60 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
Our town, a place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch, a place to sit back and watch the world go by, a place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Start your holiday season at Wichita Baptist University's 30th annual Festival of Christmas. With new music, classic favorites, fun characters, and stirring moments, there is something magical for everyone. Whether it's your 13th time or your first, you do not want to miss this exciting tradition December 2nd and 3rd. Join us for Festival Christmas. Tickets are on sale now at obu.edu/boxoffice.
Central on the move, trying to keep that 6-game winning streak alive, but Wichita's a 9-game winning streak, and the Tigers of Wichita lead the Tigers of East Central 7-0 here as we begin second quarter action.
They'll have a fresh set of downs at the Wichita 43-yard line to start this second quarter of play. Wichita leading 7-0, but here comes East Central from the 43. Hernser, straight drop, lots of time across the middle, open receiver all the way to the Wichita 26-yard line, bringing it in for East Central, Laquan Wells. You just cannot give Hernser that much time, Richard.
No, Wichita's done a decent job putting pressure on him so far tonight, but not that time. They're going 5 wide receivers again.
Boy, he had forever that time. This time, straight drop. This time a little pressure on him, in trouble, gets away. He's being pulled down and just throws the ball away as he was about to be sacked, and it'll be 2nd and 10. Now they're going to say,
I think there's going to be a holding.
Holding, okay, on East Central.
Right as the defensive line for Wichita broke through, which is only a 3-man rush, they threw a flag at that point.
All right. So we will see if they move back the Tigers of East Central.
Yeah, they've.
It was a first down at the 25-yard line. Hernser was just about to be sacked, and they are going to call the holding penalty.
That's so, a 3-man rush, Rex.
Yep.
Wichita did a good job of getting back there to him.
Be 1st and 20 from the 35. So we'll see if this will be one of those drives, Jeff, where the Tiger defense bends but does not break.
It has happened so far tonight and through much of the season. So Wichita will try to do it one more time.
First down and 20. Ball at the 35 of Wichita. They set on the near hash mark. Now moving right to left, trailing 7-0. Hernser with Miles as Davis as his running back. Hernser's going to pass yet again, though. Pass left side incomplete. Intended receiver on the play, Greg Howe.
He had him open, just missed him, and he had plenty of time. Wichita, what they're doing is they're rushing three, leaving one guy up, Jax Miller, as a spy, and he can run in there, especially if Hernser escapes the pocket, try and put a hit on him as he's trying to throw it. But they're dropping coverage and just saying, hey, find the open guy, and we're going to bet on the fact that you're not going to be able to do it all the way down the field on us. And right now on that play, it worked.
And they've about given up on the running game at this point, Jeff, it seems like.
Which is surprising because it has worked tonight. But when you've got second and 20, expect another pass.
Yep, second down and 20. Hernser out of the shotgun. Davis set to his left. Hernser rolls left. Now throws a quick pass that's going to go for only 5 yards before the receiver falls out of bounds on the Wichita sideline. That was Jaquan Lincoln bringing it in. All right, Richard, really big play. We'll say it again. Third and 15 this time from the 30.
Well, with that play, just such a short yardage one, you have to wonder if they're worried more about getting in field goal range than a first down, because that was a pass that never really had a chance to go for first down.
On third and 15, I expect Hernser to go deep. Two wideouts to the right side, along with a tight end to that right side. One wideout to the left side. One back to his left. Now they give on the ground, trying to catch Wichita asleep, and they did not. Good job that time by Wichita's Mikey Gonzalez.
What a fine play by Gonzalez. He had a big week last week, and here he is sprinting away from an offensive tackle to get the tackle in the backfield. Another tackle for loss for Mikey Gonzalez.
All right, so a very long field goal, Richard. This will be a 49-yard attempt.
I think as long on the year as 47.
Alexis Lopez, a 49-yard attempt, got the distance and is good. Lopez puts it through, and with 13:15 remaining in the first half, East Central's on the board. Our score, Wichita 7, East Central Oklahoma 3, Wichita football 2022, presented by Bison Hunt Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Wichita Sports Digital Network.
Not 75, because it was a field goal. That's instead going to be a 38-yard drive, but they still came up with 3 points, and so it's Wichita 7, East Central 3, 13:15 left.
And just a gorgeous sunset we're looking at here in late October, cool night in Arkadelphia. You know, most fields go north and south. This one, which has been here for more than 60 years, is one of those weird east-west fields, and Wichita is now going east, but as we look behind them to the west across Henderson's Carpenter Haygood Stadium, boy, just as pretty a sunset as I've ever seen.
Yeah, Richard. Arkadelphia is showing off tonight because it is truly beautiful. You can't picture a better night for football than this.
Alexis Lopez, who just connected on the 49-yard field goal to get East Central on the board, will kick off. High kick going to go into the end zone and be returned out over the 10, out over the 15, out over the 25, out to the 28-yard line. Brought out by Wichita's Justin Dean. So here comes the offense again, Jeff. That offense went 3-and-out on its most recent possession.
We do see Givens checking back in. That's good news. He was hit hard on a lower leg on his first carry of the night and left the game, but he's back in for this possession.
That is good to see because you can't put it all on T.J. Cole. You like that 1-2 punch. So the sophomore from Little Rock Christian, Kendall Givens, back in the football game. Tigers work out of the pistol. Harms takes the snap. Gives to Kendall Givens. Kendall Givens has got running room, runs over a man, and goes for an 11-yard gain to the 39.
Well, he looked pretty good on that run right there. That was kind of his patented finish to run, bounce off a tackle. They got him for they tackled him from behind after he bounced that off, but that's a first down, the second longest run for the Tigers tonight. And he looks okay. He was running on the sidelines after that, trying to just kind of think, work that, and maybe it was just a pop on an ankle or a shin, just trying to work it out. Looks like he's okay.
Well, that was a quick 11 yards for Washita. Tigers moving left to right, leading 7-3. Riley Harms looking to pass deep. Across the middle of the field. Wide open receiver at the 40 at the 35. Down to the 30-yard line of East Central. Coming up with the football for Washita, Hunter Swoboda. Another of those seniors on senior night, Jeff.
And he was open down the middle, and he's a big target. Swoboda came up with it. He's not targeted all that often, but he's got very good hands. He's a great blocker, and that time he was an outstanding receiver.
That went for 31 yards, Richard.
Yeah, he had to go up for that one. And that was – Washita set that up earlier with the fake – they tossed it to T.J. Cole. This time they fake tossed it to Kendall Givens and then went deep. And Washita was going to go with the direct snap, but we're going to have a timeout on the field from East Central.
East Central will take the timeout, and we will pause. 12-10 left in the first half. Washita 7, East Central Oklahoma 3. Washita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Ferris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
Now managed by the Van Dorn Group, Sonic of Arkadelphia is ready to get involved in the Arkadelphia community. With the goal of making improvements to the Arkadelphia restaurant, the Van Dorn Group is committed to making Sonic of Arkadelphia one of the best around. Stop by Sonic of Arkadelphia today for a Route 44 slush or drink to go with the great Sonic burgers, tater tots, or french fries. Top it off with your favorite ice cream treat. Visit Sonic of Arkadelphia on 10th Street today.
12 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the second quarter. This is really a fine contest between two excellent teams. The Tigers of Washita 7, the Tigers of East Central Oklahoma 3. Washita is driving.
Washita comes in with an 8-0 record. East Central is 6-2. So the biggest game thus far in the season, Richard, in the GAC. Commissioner's here tonight, among others.
Yeah, he's here, and it is a big game. And for Washita, you know, you want to win this one, and it keeps getting bigger after that if you win this one.
First down and 10. They will go with the direct snap this time to T.J. Cole. On first down, Cole got a – no, it closed up. I was going to say a bit of a hole, and the ball was – pulled out, it looked like, for a minute. Referee's down there looking, and Cole's back on top of it.
Yeah, I mean, it was out. He fumbled that, but he also knew it, and he fumbled. He jumped right back on it. As we talked about it, East Central will force some fumbles, and they recover a lot of them. They've recovered. We talked about it earlier. They've recovered 14 on the year. They've forced now 20.
Well, they're doing a good job against the Washita ground game so far. That was a loss of 2. Now Kendall Givens will come back in out of the pistol. Tigers send a man in motion. That's Justin Dean going left to right. Pitch to Givens coming right. Breaks a tackle, but is forced out of bounds fairly quickly.
Yeah, when you pitch to the short side of the field, he broke a tackle by jumping outside of somebody. Well, then he had nowhere to go going upfield. He was just kind of out of bounds and got a couple maybe. Gained back what was lost on the low bit of the fumble.
So third and long, let's call it third and 11, Washita from the 31. Tigers need to make something happen here. Remember, their top kicker, Gabe Goodman, is out for a third consecutive week. Harms with Givens set to his right to block. It will be a passing situation. Harms throwing right side, caught on the sideline. What a great job by Washita's Tucker Swoboda. But we got a flag down, Richard.
We got two in the backfield, and Washita's walking backwards. It was a great catch because Swoboda had to kind of readjust at the last minute, catch it falling out of bounds. But
wow.
Yeah, it's going to come back. And that was a hold as Washita got beat inside and basically tackled the defender going upfield.
And now you are definitely out of field goal range, Jeff. So something big is going to have to happen now, way back at the 41, where it is 3rd and 21.
Now it's 4-down territory.
It is good to see Swoboda back in. He was injured. Younger brother of the senior, Hunter, Tucker Swoboda, is in the game.
Two wideouts to either side on 3rd and 21. Harms can't find anybody, and boy, no, it's punt time, Richard. It's not 4-down time
sacked,
now
yeah.
When you get sacked back at the 47.
If they got 5 or 10 yards, it might have been punt, but he never had a chance that time.
Wow, that is unfortunate.
Getting back there for the sack was Kayvon Curry. He's playing that right defensive end. It just ran a stunt that time, and Wichita was not ready for it.
4th and 27, so the Tigers have a first down down at the 30-yard line, and they go backward from there. Very unfortunate turn of events. Here is the punt, going to be allowed to bounce. Another good one inside the 10 down to the 9-yard line. Well, the Tigers are in a battle, Jeff, as the defense comes back on, and the lead is just 4 at 7-3.
And another fine job by Couch to drop that inside the 20, and then it rolled down to the 9.
A media timeout, Wichita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
If you or a loved one gets hurt in an accident, you need true care and concern. You can hand us everything, the bills, the paperwork, and anything else you need help with,
so you can focus on recovering from your injury.
That's why people turn to the Taylor King Law Firm.
You need an attorney with integrity and experience in dealing with the complex details.
We do everything we can to relieve the stress and take care of your family.
If you're injured in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
We'll be on your side, by your side.
9 minutes, 41 seconds left. Second quarter action, Wichita 7, East Central 3. East Central has the ball back, but they have to start inside their own 10.
So bottled up back at the 9, we'll see if this black-clad Wichita defense can keep them bottled up. Hernser is the quarterback. Herod is the running back. Herod set behind Hernser in the pistol now. From the 9, so they may go back to the ground down here. And up there, passing again. Hernser goes right side, got a receiver at the 10, tackle made out to about the 14-yard line. And so a short gain that time before Dante Gibson makes the tackle, second down.
Decent recovery because Wichita was expecting a run too, as Ty Compton, the outside linebacker, I think would have probably been in coverage there. Came down hard expecting the run and then had to bail out at the last second. So
second and 5 after the gain of 5. See if they go back to the ground here with Herod set in the pistol behind Hernser. No, Hernser passing again right down the line of scrimmage. Another missed tackle, but not the second one at the 15. First one was missed, but another of those seniors was there, Ty Compton, to make the tackle, Jeff. Now a big third down and 4.
When that ball was caught, it looked like he had a lot of space, but a good job to slow him down, and then the pursuit caught up for a short gain and a big third down coming.
Third and 4, if they force a 3-and-out, Wichita should have good field position on third down. Would expect Hernser to be passing yet again. That's mostly what he has done thus far tonight. Wichita leading 7-3. Hernser on third down, straight drop back this time, across the middle of the field, caught at the 21-yard line. Bringing it in for East Central is Jake Berry, and Wichita unable, Richard, to keep East Central deep and make them punt.
Yeah, he just got right past the first down marker and turned around and waited for the football and made a nice catch. Didn't try to do anything extra, just kind of fell down with it and easily able to get that first down, just a quick curl route.
So East Central out of the hole now with a fresh set of downs. Hernser, lots of room to work. Rolls to his right. Passing wide open receiver. Out over the 40. Out to the 44-yard line. And here comes East Central again. This time it was Jaquan Lincoln. And the Tigers of East Central, Jeff, on the move. They've moved all the way from their 9 out to their 41-yard line.
Receiver got there, and the defender was just a bit late, missed the interception. Instead, a nice run down the sideline for good yardage.
44 is where they call it. That's a 23-yard gain on first down. East Central outplaying Wichita at this point in the football game. Trips to the near side, out of the pistol. Hernser again passing right down that line of scrimmage, and it's dropped. Intended receiver that time, Jaquan Lincoln. He just dropped it, Richard, and it's second and 10 from the 41.
Well, he may have heard he had a linebacker and safety bearing down on him pretty quick. He would have gotten nowhere, and so I think he was kind of looking at that. And so I think he might would have gained 1 yard, might would have lost 1 yard, kind of in that range. Well, they end up with nothing there, and second and 10.
Second and 10, I said 41, meant 44. From the 44-yard line, East Central comes back to work. They're moving right to left in the second quarter, trailing Wichita by four. Hernser out of the shotgun, one man to his right to block on second down. Hernser, nope, he's going to give on the ground this time, and the tackle is made immediately by Wichita's Rovell Carter.
Man, he was back there in the backfield quick and never had a chance to get away, and Carter gets the big tackle. Now a third and long situation. This is a big play for the Wichita defense. They've forced the punt a few times in these situations, but ECU's offense has been clicking a little bit lately. Can't allow it now. They're going to send in another safety. Trey Proctor going to come in and play that middle safety.
This is huge. Third down and 12, East Central, working from its 42, trailing Wichita 7-3 in the second quarter. Hernser out of the shotgun on third down. Straight drop back. Has time. Comes left side. Caught! First down all the way down to the Wichita 35-yard line, and getting up and posing is Jaquan Lincoln.
That was a great catch and a great pass and good coverage. Johnson was there. He just could not quite get to the ball because it was so well delivered. Big play for East Central.
Wow. First down and 10. East Central trying to take its first lead of the night on the move. Two men split to either side. Hernser out of the shotgun, straight drop back, can't find anybody open, tries to run and is immediately tackled. Going to be a loss back to the 38-yard line this time. Second and 13, but the Tigers have been unable thus far on this possession, Richard, to take advantage of these long yarded situations, the Wichita defense.
Yeah, great job by Butler, Mikey Gonzalez that time to get him down as he was starting to run. It was a lost yards, but yeah, you're right. On this drive, really has not made a difference as East Central's been able to make the yards through the air pretty well.
Second down and 13. One running back to the left is Miles Davis, but Hernser will be passing again, I'm sure. Passing almost every play now. No, he runs, calls his own number. And he's going to have big yardage inside the 30. He's all the way down to the Wichita 26-yard line, where it's going to bring up third down and only a yard now needed for a first down, Jeff.
Well, we had heard from Richard earlier that he's a good runner. He showed it that time. Really ran well in traffic, made a couple of good cuts, and then dove forward but fell short of the first down. So Wichita still has an opportunity here.
Third and one, this Wichita defense cannot figure it out right now. Third down and one from the 26-yard line, and it's going to be a first down.
Wichita got good penetration on the right side, but East Central, or the right side of the line of scrimmage, East Central was going to the other side and was able to get that first down. And this is the part of the field where the Wichita defense normally gets even tougher and does not allow people to the end zone. But they're going to need to – they've got a tall task here as East Central's been moving the ball well.
All right, third down and one. Ball at the 20 – or excuse me, first down and 10 after the game there. Ball at the 23-yard line. First down and 10 from the 23. Hernser out of the pistol, rolling to his right, and it is going to be a pass out of bounds as Wichita had a big rush on him, Jeff, and he just threw it away.
It sure looked like he was throwing it away, but it was almost complete on the far sideline over there. Good coverage by Wichita forced him to throw it just before the defense finally got there as he roamed back and back and to his right and finally had to get rid of it.
And so it is going to be second down and 10 now with the ball at the 23-yard line of Wichita. East Central trying to take its first lead of the evening, trailing Ouachita 7-3. 3:52 is what we have remaining. Straight drop back, Hernser, and we've got whistles now, Richard.
It's going to be a false start, I believe, on East Central. They are signaling that, so they're going to be moving back 5 yards. Could be on one of the receivers.
All right. So back to the 28 this time, where it'll be second down and 15. Second and 15 from the 28, 3:49 is what we have remaining in this first half of play, which has been dominated by the defenses so far, but East Central trying to take the lead. Straight drop back, Hernser gets away from the rush, throws it into the end zone, too high. Boy, good rush by Ouachita. Hernser was able to get away, tried to get the ball down to Jaquan Lincoln in the end zone, Jeff, but threw it too high, and it's going to bring up third down.
He was open, but he had stopped running, and the ball was thrown as if he was going to continue to run to the back of the end zone. It was also hurried because the Ouachita defense was getting to the quarterback, but another dangerous play, and third down coming.
Third down and 15, ball at the 28-yard line of Ouachita. Huge play right here. Hernser out of the shotgun. Straight drop back, throws right side, one-on-one coverage, and it's going to be incomplete. Intended receiver again was Jaquan Lincoln, but with him step for step was the junior Andrew Hayes.
And that was as good a coverage as you can draw up there, Rex, as there was no chance of getting that. And the receiver actually ran out of bounds trying to get past Hayes. The official threw his hat. So that never had a chance, and they're going to try for another field goal and good stand there from the defense, not letting him get any closer.
So this will be a 45-yard attempt this time from Alexis Lopez. Lopez trying it from 45 and putting it through. And this lead is 1-7-6, Ouachita. Ouachita 7, East Central Oklahoma 6. Ouachita football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Make Print Mania in downtown Arkadelphia your place to get embroidery, screen printing, trophies, and more. Drop by their store on Main Street in downtown Arkadelphia or visit their website at printmaniatees.com to see how they can help your business or group. Need a shirt for an event? Let Print Mania take care of that. Need promotional materials for your business or organization? You can let Print Mania take care of that too. A family-run local business in Arkadelphia, Print Mania has been serving the public since 1992. Call Print Mania today, 870-246-3803.
Here comes the kick. Let's see if Ouachita can get any points on the board before halftime. It'll go into and out of the back of the end zone. So they'll start 75 yards away, and Ouachita with a one-point lead here, Richard, really needs to get some offense going and try to get some points on this board before halftime.
Well, you know, they've had two fumbles. One was the first drive of the game when they were driving down. They fumbled about the 20-yard line. The next one was when they were got down about – and they lost that one – down about the 35-yard line, and they fumbled on first down and went negative yards, and both those have stalled the drives. It's so important to not fumble the football and hold on against this defense.
First down and 10 from the 25-yard line. Kendall Givens trying to come right, 3 yards to the 28. Good pursuit that time by Cameron Jones. And, Jeff, we have a flag down on the play.
It's back at the 23-yard line and a spot where it looks like it's going to be a blocking foul against Ouachita. It's going to push him back.
Ha! Wow! Wow! Just been frustrating turnovers and penalties tonight, Richard, thus far on Ouachita.
Yeah, and I don't know about that one. That was kind of a push down as he was going through. He pushed him down from the side. I didn't see much there. But
that really hurts, though.
It's going to be a passing situation here on until they get a first down, first and 20.
Yeah, you go to first and 20 now, and you have to go back to the air when you're a run-first team. The lead is 1-7-6. Harms can't find anybody open. Now he does to the left side out at the 20-yard line, And that's all that it's going to be, as another good open field tackle is made after a gain of five. And it's going to be a passing situation yet again, Jeff, second and 15 from the 20-yard line.
East Central has really done well, except for that one drive, and Wichita scored from long yardage on three plays. They made a couple of mistakes. Wichita took advantage for the 7 points. Otherwise, this ECU defense has excelled.
They really have. Second down and 15. Wichita. Now did Wichita move?
False start on Wichita.
Wow.
I mean, quite frankly, the offensive line is not playing what you're used to seeing from Wichita offensive line. They've had two holds, a sack given up. There's a false start, and all the yards they got back, they got on first down, those 5 yards are gone away. And now
absolutely.
It's back to second and 20.
Second and 20 now. Man, they are really struggling. Wichita holds the lead, but they're in a fight tonight, and they are not looking good thus far. Second and 20 from the 15-yard line. Harms out of the shotgun. Straight drop this time. Has some time. Now he's forced out of the pocket. Rolling to his right. Dumps it off. Catch is made out at the 30. Nice job that time coming up with it by Justin Dean. Going to bring up third down, Jeff, but it's third and short at least.
Maybe one of the best passes we've seen of the season from Harms. He was running full steam, fired to the sideline, and hit his man downfield on the numbers. Really fine pass. Gives Washington an opportunity now.
Third down, East Central is going to call a timeout, but I'm going to hold it here. I want to reset. So what you have is a third and four at the 31, 2:02 remaining. And the thing that makes this such a crucial play, Richard, late in the first half is you want to keep the ball out of Hernser and that offense's hand. They have the momentum now, even though they haven't scored a touchdown. They have two long field goals, and 2 minutes would be plenty of time for them to take the lead in at halftime if you give the ball up here.
Plus, they get the ball to start the second half
exactly.
as well, so you got to think about those. But, yeah, it's important to not just get a first down here, though. That Washington needs to go down and score. Their offense has not been clicking today. That's what happens when you completely take away the run game. And really, some of that's been just self-inflicted wounds, holdings and stuff. And when you get those 10-yard penalties, it's hard to go back to a run when it's first and 20 or second and 20. And so that's really what's been hurting them.
Third and four. So this is a huge play in this first half. Tigers holding a narrow 7-6 lead. On third down and four, straight drop back. Carm's got a receiver out at the 38-yard line. Good job by Connor Flanagan bringing it in, Jeff.
He did a fine job, and it's another good pass. Last two plays have looked more like that Wichita offense. They like to get the running game going, but with less than 2 minutes to play now in the half, they'll probably keep throwing the ball. Harms is looking good.
Tigers need to get at least three out of this possession. They lead by one, 7-6. Clock is running, 1:45 remaining in the first half. Tigers coming out of the pistol. Give left, looking for running room and finding some. Up over the 40, all the way to the 44 goes Kendall Givens, and that's a gain of 6 yards.
6 yards, but down to 1:30 left to go before halftime. Still plenty of time. Washington's got three timeouts, but they're going to have to pass the ball some.
Second down and four. Tigers out of the pistol. Givens again runs over a man, goes over midfield to the 49 of East Central. Gain of 7, Jeff. And another first down.
He's looking very, very good. And now a whistle blows, and Washington's going to take a timeout.
And we will pause this time. 1:17 left in the first half. It's Washington 7, East Central Oklahoma 6. Washington football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washington Football Network.
Back to action, 1:17 left before halftime. And Wichita lines up. They need 49 more yards to stretch out this lead.
From the 49-yard line, straight drop back. This time, Harms forced out of the pocket. Throws on the run and almost intercepted. Good job breaking up the pass that time by East Central's Jalen Baldwin.
Yeah, he had a beat on that one. That pass was just a tad bit behind the receiver, and Baldwin almost had that interception. That would have been a backbreaker, but that's what that defense has done all year.
Boy, I thought he had an interception. Two men split left this time. Harms passing again, going deep, one-on-one coverage. All kinds of contact, but no flag down there. Quite a bit of pushing, Richard, but they did not throw a flag on Keontae Lusk.
Yeah, well, Tucker Sabota was doing his fair share of pushing as well. I don't necessarily blame him for not calling that one. Wichita, when you're put in these situations where they have to pass, obviously they don't. It's a little harder because the play action does not work. And here's third and 10 as they've tried two longer passes. And, well, they tried to go long on the first one, ended up going short, and has not worked. We'll see if they can get something 10 yards, see if they can get Connor Flanagan just past the sticks, turn around, and get a first down.
Third down and 10, straight drop back. Pass going deep down the middle of the field. And it's caught! And it's got inside the 10-yard line. Connor Flanagan coming up with the football.
Double move, and he completely turned the defensive back around. It looked like he was going for a post on the inside and then just cut out to the outside. The defender never had a chance. That's a tough catch, Rex. That's over the shoulder. That's the Willie Mays style that time out in the outfield. That's a tough catch.
They mark it at the 9-yard line with a minute still left, plenty of time. Now Harms is going to run for it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land. Touchdown, Riley Harms. Touchdown, Wichita.
Set up by that big, big pass. And then we think Washington's going to throw it into the end zone. The seas open that time, and Riley Harms able to walk in for a touchdown. And that's big, Rex.
Oh, it's huge right before halftime. That's what we were talking about. Washington badly needed some momentum. So on to attempt the extra point for Wichita is Dax Jaggers. Snap, hold, kick. Good, and the lead is 8. Wichita, 14. East Central Oklahoma, 6 with 55 seconds left. We're just past the top of the hour, so let's pause for station identification on this, the Wichita Football Network.
Whether you realize it or not, you see the work of bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Wichita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Sign did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
To Flanagan for 41 yards and then an 8-yard touchdown run by quarterback Riley Harms. Wichita 14, East Central 6 with 55 seconds left in the first half.
Now you have to play defense for 55 seconds. Here's Jaggers, kick. High but short, caught at the 11. Brought out over the 20, forced out of bounds at the 20, where is he going to stop, 7-yard line. So first down and 10, and you just don't want to give up anything deep here, Richard.
Yeah, but you can't let them, you can't be worried about deep. I mean, you hit 3 or 4 10-yard patterns, and all of a sudden you're in business. So you still got to play just a regular base defense. You don't want to sit back and play prevent. You might keep one or two guys a little deeper, but you don't want to get too soft. 51 seconds, timeout left, passing team. I mean, that's still plenty of time.
Tigers are in a battle, Jeff. Been very impressed with this East Central team so far.
Let's see if they go with the 3-man rush or hype it up a little bit. They have had success when they put pressure on the quarterback.
3-down linemen rushing this time. Hernser passing right side. Got a receiver and a first down. To the far sideline, that's the East Central sideline at the 38. And so it'll be a gain of 11 and a fresh set of downs. And that didn't take much time off the clock, Richard.
Nope, just took about 5 seconds off. 46.6 seconds left now as they'll get ready for this next first down.
Don't want to give up many of those or they're back in field goal range, as we have already seen Alexis Lopez hit two field goals on the evening for East Central. Again, a three-man rush for Ouachita. Hernser, pass tipped, almost intercepted. Boy, trying to get there, Jeff, was Ouachita's Andrew Hayes after the tip. He couldn't get there, and it's second down and 10.
Dawson Miller helping out as well. I tell you what, when you rush three, you got eight guys back there, and they almost tipped it to one another that time. Would have been a big turnover with 43 seconds left.
So line back up with 43 seconds left in the half, and Ouachita leading 14-6. Hernser, an empty backfield. Receivers to either side, straight drop back. Looking, going down the right side. It ain't Trout and caught and out of bounds, but how did he come up with that ball as Ouachita had two defenders there, and they're in field goal range already, Richard, at the 26.
Yeah, I don't know how he came up with that. That was a heck of a catch. It looked like Ouachita was going to have good coverage, and luckily he stepped out of bounds. Otherwise, because Ouachita had nobody back there on deeper than that to stop him from going in the end zone. But you're right, back in field goal range.
Here they come, 36 seconds still left. Ouachita may have to hope that it's just a field goal at this point, because East Central in range to score right here. At the 26 of Ouachita, quickly coming down the field. Hernser can't find anybody open, going to run for big yardage. 15 all the way down to the Ouachita 10-yard line, Jeff. That's a 16-yard gain on the scramble.
And they'll stop the clock to move the chain. Still 28 seconds left. Now clock running.
And he threw it three times in the end zone from here. From the 10, Hernser sets up, goes into the end zone. That one too high, too far. Good coverage by Ouachita on the coverage for the Tigers that time. Mario Ganter Jr., but he gets two more tosses in the end zone, Richard. Plenty of time.
Yeah, and they can actually get a first down inside the five, around the, one-yard line, they can have a first down. I don't think they're thinking that. They're thinking end zone, but they don't technically have to get to the end zone to reset the sticks.
Yeah, second down and 10. They are just outside the 10. You are right. So let's call it second and 10 from the 11 with 18 seconds left in this first half. Hernser will be chunking it again, and this time we got whistles.
Yeah, Ouachita, the defensive backfield is not happy about something. They were signaling the sidelines. I don't know if they didn't have a call or they were short somebody, so Washington's going to take a timeout.
So we will pause. 17 seconds left to go in the first half. It's Ouachita 14, East Central Oklahoma 6. Ouachita football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Visit the Ouachita campus store for all your Tiger apparel, merchandise, and gifts. If you need something to wear to show your Tiger pride, stop by the Ouachita campus store on the bottom floor of the Evans Student Center to grab a t-shirt, sweatshirt, polo, or more. If you can't stop by the store on campus, visit us online at bookstore.obu.edu. Make your purchase and we'll send it to you. Support the Tigers by checking out the Ouachita campus store. Go Tigers.
Well, that's not official.
Threatening to catch up to the Ouachita Tigers here before halftime. Ouachita 14, East Central 6, but East Central is driving.
Second down and 10 from the Ouachita 11. Hernser will be passing into the end zone, I would suspect, here as he comes from the far hash mark. Hernser, straight drop, big rush, dumps it off, left side, tipped away. Good job that time by Washita's Dante Gibson.
Yeah, they had the safety on an island back there because Ouachita brought the pressure, and Gibson did a great job knocking it away. East Central wanted interference. I didn't even see any contact back there, but we were talking about it in the break. Ouachita's got to bring a little more pressure. They did that time, and it was still a pretty decent throw from Hernser, though.
Third down and 10 from the 11, and Hernser will be throwing it into the end zone yet again. Let's see if Ouachita can get another stop and force a field goal attempt here. Hernser out of the shotgun. One man set to his right to block with 12 seconds left in the first half. Hernser, straight drop, rush on him, in trouble. Sacked, back at the 18-yard line.
Mikey Gonzalez in there. Ty Compton on the blitz, but great job by Compton and Gonzalez. And East Central is going to have to kick a field goal. Rex, so far this year, Washtenaw has allowed opponents in the red zone 19 times and only given up a touchdown on six of them, if you include that one. Very impressive stand by the Washtenaw defense.
So Alexis Lopez will attempt a 35-yard field goal. He's already got two on the evening tonight, Jeff.
He's a very, very good field goal kicker, left-footed kicker. He's got a great leg. Just a matter of hitting it through the uprights. He was close on his last make. We'll see if he misses this time.
From the far hash mark, a 35-yard attempt for Lopez to bring it back to a one-score game at halftime. Snap, hold, the kick is a low one. It is no good. He missed it. The Tigers have dodged a bullet to end the first half. That's big, 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 Dr. Root.
I tell you what, we thought it was big when the Tigers scored with 55 seconds left, but that's huge also. Slipped it too far to the left and banged it off the upright.
And look at this sideline. That miss, Richard, gives Washtenaw the momentum at halftime.
Well, it looked like, yeah, it might have been a possible one-point game in a minute ago. Well, they end up now with going in with an 8-point lead, and the defense came up big, and then that miss. That's how you end the half there, Rex.
Still a one-possession game, Richard, and Washtenaw is in a battle. Much like the Harding game, this reminds me of.
Yeah, and ECU gets the ball to start the second half, but I think what we saw in those last two plays, Rex, you got to bring pressure. You got to bring pressure on Hertzer. Not every play, but you got to bring some because those last two plays, an incompletion and then a sack.
Jeff, we've got quite a ball game on our hands at Cliff Harris Stadium.
You do get the idea that because the ECU defense has been up to the task against the Washtenaw running attack, that this is going to be a four-quarter game this week.
You absolutely do. So that concludes the first half with our score. Washtenaw Baptist University 14, East Central Oklahoma 6. Coming up, the Southern Bancorp Tiger Recap. That's coming your way in 2 minutes here on the Washtenaw Football Network, presented by Visit Hot Springs.
He's actually, yeah, he's returning to full-time teaching.
And now, Tiger Nation, here they come, your 2022 Washtenaw Marching Band. The band is under the field direction of drum major Josh Sutton. Tonight, we continue our second show of the season, a tribute to the music of Motown. I Want You Back was the first national single released by the Jackson 5 in 1969. It went to number one and sold over 6 million copies. The song was reintroduced to this generation in the Guardians of the Galaxy movie in 2014. Here is I Want You Back. written by Ashford and Simpson in 1966. Ain't No Mountain High Enough was first a hit single for in 1967 for Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell. It became a hit again in 1970 when Diana Ross recorded it. Its recent popularity is due once again to the Guardians of the Galaxy movies. Here is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Tiger faithful, it's time to get on your feet and do what you do best. Please join us now in our fight song and cheer our Tigers on to another victory. Washington Marching Band! Craig Hamilton, as always, we thank you for your support and go Tigers!
Great options at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And don't forget about our amazing desserts. Welcome to the Aurora Rundown. I'm Brody Kriegel. Wachita's fall sports teams are getting closer to championship month. Teams are looking to end October strong as many position themselves for postseason play. We begin with football as the top five Wachita football team moved to 8-0 after beating Southern Arkansas in the Murphy USA Classic 63-31. After trailing the Mule Riders 14-7 in the first quarter, the Tigers went ahead and never looked back, scoring 9 total touchdowns. This is the third game this season where Wachita has scored more than 60 points, and the first time that this has happened since 1942. Behind another solid effort from the offensive line, running back T.J. Cole dominated the ballgame with 230 yards rushing and tied a GAC record with 6 rushing touchdowns. Cole's second consecutive 200-yard rushing game led him to back-to-back GAC Offensive Player of the Week awards. The Tigers have a quick turnaround as they will play their final regular season home game of the season on Thursday night as East Central comes to Cliff Harris Stadium for a 6 p.m. kickoff. Senior night ceremonies will take place before the game. Women's soccer is entering the final week of the regular season, with Wachita currently tied for first place in the conference after a 4-4 draw with Harding on Tuesday. The top team will host the conference tournament starting next week. The tie with Harding was the team's 4th straight tie as last Saturday, the women finished in a 0-0 draw against Northwestern Oklahoma State. The last two matches of the regular season will determine whether Wachita, Southwestern Oklahoma State, or Oklahoma Baptist will win the regular season title and host the conference tournament. November 3rd and 5th, Wachita wraps regular season play Thursday in Ada, Oklahoma against East Central. Both Southwestern and Oklahoma Baptist play Thursday and Saturday. Last Thursday, volleyball completed a season sweep of Henderson State, beating the Reddies 3-0. Riley Brazil led in kills with 10, and Wachita had a season-high 11 blocks, with Haley Fairchild recording 8, which is also a team high for the season. This win followed a 3-0 sweep of UAM the week before and made this the Tigers' 5th straight win by scores of 3-0. The win against Henderson State clinched the Tigers a berth in the GAC Volleyball Tournament in early November. Wachita will wrap up regular season play next week with 2 matches. The final home match of the season will be Tuesday, November 1st in the senior night match versus Arkansas Tech. In other Tiger sports, the swim teams lost their first Battle of the Ravine meet at Henderson, and men's soccer is set to play its last home match and honor its seniors this Saturday at 2 o'clock p.m. versus Harding at Cluck Field. That's all for the Roar Rundown. Back to you.
This is Anthony Sherez. Thank you for tuning in to Wachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Joe Couch. Thank you for watching the Wachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Terrell Gibson. Thanks for watching Wachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Kendall Gibbons. Thanks for watching Wachita Sports Digital Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer: caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help. To be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
Our town, a place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch, a place to sit back and watch the world go by, a place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Start your holiday season at Wachita Baptist University's 30th annual Festival of Christmas. With new music, classic favorites, fun characters, and stirring moments, there is something magical for everyone. Whether it's your 13th time or your first, you do not want to miss this exciting tradition December 2nd and 3rd. Join us for Festival of Christmas. Tickets are on sale now at obu.edu/boxoffice.
Whether you realize it or not, you see the work of bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Ouachita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Sign did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
This is the Week 8 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell. East Central is now on a six-game win streak for the first time since 1984 after its 42-28 win over Southwestern Oklahoma State and a 99th meeting between the two teams. With the game tied 14-14 in the second quarter, ECU scored 28 straight points to build a 35-14 lead midway through the third quarter. Swasu added two touchdowns to set the 14-point margin, but the Tigers never lost control. Kenny Hearns here threw for 239 yards and three touchdowns, including this 88-yard touchdown pass to Jaquan Lincoln on the first play of the drive early in the third quarter. Here's Mike Manos of X Factor Radio with the call.
And they will have it at their own 12-yard line after the punt by Van Winkle. Back to pass, Kenny going long down the middle of the field. Wide open, Link at the 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, down the sidelines, 10, 5, touchdown, Tigers! 88 yards to number one, and the Tigers blow it open.
Ouachita running back T.J. Cole put together his second consecutive game of 200-plus yards rushing and tied a GAC record with six rushing touchdowns, helping number four Ouachita move to 8-0 with a 63-31 win over SAU in the Murphy USA Classic in El Dorado, Arkansas. Southern Arkansas held an early 14-7 lead, but the Tigers took control with the ground game and built a 35-17 lead themselves. SAU would cut the Ouachita lead to 11 in the third quarter, but a strong fourth quarter from the Tigers put the game out of reach. Cole's fifth touchdown of the game came early in the fourth quarter and gave Ouachita a 49-31 lead. Here's Rex Nelson on the Ouachita Football Network.
On the direct snap, it will go to the senior All-American, T.J. Cole. Cole calls for the snap. Takes it. Goes over right tackle to the two. Cole to the one. Cole to the land of milk and honey. Touchdown, Ouachita, with 10:52 left in the fourth quarter.
It was a high-scoring affair in Monticello Saturday as Harding outscored UAM 56-43. The Bison's strong ground game resulted in four touchdowns, but it was a 75-yard touchdown pass and a 97-yard fumble return for a score that put separation between the Bisons and the Boll Weevils. Harding led 28-21 at halftime and extended the lead on a 75-yard touchdown from Cole Keelon to Cage City with just under 10 minutes left in the third quarter. Clark Griffin then returned to fumble 97 yards for a score 3 minutes later. Here's the call from Billy Morgan on the Harding Sports Network.
And now it's fourth and goal from the one. Empty backfield from the one. They're going to go. Snap it to Kleinpeter. Kleinpeter, he lost the football. It's scooped up and returned. Picked up at the 3-yard line down the left sideline. And nobody is going to catch Griffin. Midfield to the 40, to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Harding. Clark Griffin scooped it up and returns it 95-plus yards. We'll see what the official return on it is, but it's a scoop and score, and the Bisons with a quick turn right there now lead it by 20.
Southeastern racked up 591 yards of total offense and got five touchdown passes from quarterback Dalton Hatley in a 62-14 win over Oklahoma Baptist. The Savage Storm led 42-0 at halftime, thanks to a 35-point second quarter, and eventually built that lead to 55-0. Hatley completed 81% of his passes and threw for 332 yards. Marquise Gray had 125 yards receiving and three touchdowns, and DeAndre Wheeler rushed for 106 yards and two touchdowns himself. Here's the first of Gray's three touchdown receptions from Jay Lindley on the Southeastern Sports Network.
Snap for the right hash on first and 10. Play action. Hatley goes right toward Gray, one-on-one, and a diving grab. Is it in? It is. Touchdown, Southeastern. Marquise Gray from 27 yards out. What does he do, Rob?
Catch touchdowns, Jade.
Make it back-to-back wins for Southern Nazarene for the first time since 2018.
after a 27-21 win over Northwestern Oklahoma State. With the game tied at 21 early in the fourth quarter, Southern Nazarene quarterback Gage Porter rushed for his third touchdown of the day on a 21-yard run with 10:38 left to play. The teams went back and forth the majority of the fourth quarter before Northwestern had a chance to tie and take the lead with a first and goal situation. Southern Nazarene forced an incompletion on fourth and goal from the 5 to secure the win. Here's that call from Sean Thurman.
So now 3 wides on the right. He's looking to the right. He throws over the middle. It is broken up. It was in the hands of Torrance Stevens. They had the look that they wanted, but the SNU secondary steps up and breaks up the pass and will take over with 1:45 left to play.
Henderson State moved to 6-2 with a 35-19 win over Arkansas Tech in the 98th meeting between the teams, thanks to a strong third quarter and the quarterback-receiver connection of Andrew Edwards and Xavier Malone. The Reddies led 21-13 at halftime before Edwards and Malone connected twice in the third quarter to stretch the Reddy lead to 35-13. Edwards passed for 302 yards on the day, 207 of which went to Malone. The second scoring strike between Edwards and Malone, an 80-yard pass on the first play of the drive, provided the last score of the day for the Reddies. Here's Blake Smith with that call on the Reddy Sports Network.
Little play fake. Edwards goes to the air. Malone one-on-one in stride. Gone. 40, 30, and Malone takes his time, and he'll stroll into the end zone. Touchdown, Reddies. 80 yards, Edwards to Malone.
This week in the GAC, we have one Thursday night game as East Central travels to Ouachita for a 6 p.m. kickoff. On Saturday, there will be 4 games kicking off at 2 p.m., including Southern Arkansas at Oklahoma Baptist, Southwestern Oklahoma State at Arkansas Tech, Southeastern Oklahoma State at Arkansas Monticello, and Henderson State at Southern Nazarene. Harding hosts Northwestern Oklahoma State in the only 3 p.m. kickoff of the day. This has been the Week 8 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell.
If you or a loved one gets hurt in an accident, you need true care and concern. You can hand us everything, the bills, the paperwork, and anything else you need help with,
so you can focus on recovering from your injury.
That's why people turn to the Taylor King Law Firm.
You need an attorney with integrity and experience in dealing with the complex details.
We do everything we can to relieve the stress and take care of your family.
If you're injured in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
We'll be on your side, by your side.
At Berry & Turnage, we specialize in bringing the law to your corner. We are dedicated to understanding what results you want and to helping you understand what actions we can take on your behalf. With over 30 years of experience and a proven track record of success, Berry & Turnage is here to lead you down a path to the results you need. We will work with you every step of the way to make sure that you understand the choices you are making and feel empowered to make them. Berry & Turnage. Serious injuries require serious attorneys.
So you're up at dawn, kid, look alive. You've been saving for a big man cave. Good luck with that, Dave. You made the most of your retirement plan, so you better learn to drive that RV. So many things you're doing in your life.
Nationwide Mutual Insurance Company and Affiliates, Columbus, Ohio.
For all your many sides, there's Nationwide. Call Jim Stillwell in Benton today, 501-776-3000.
In a dogfight here tonight, Dax Jaggers, the freshman, will kick off. So Tigers of East Central will get the ball first to start this second half. Jaggers' kick is going to go into the end zone. Touchback back to the 25. First down and 10 from the 25. So East Central has moved the football pretty well tonight, Richard, but they don't have any touchdowns on the board.
Yeah, that's what Ouachita's done a good job of all year, not allowing opponents to score, especially when they get down inside the red zone. Now, two of those were – the two field goals they got were great long field goals. They missed the short one that they had, Rex, to end the first half. So down 14-6 now, but still, like you said, at the end of the first half, a one-possession ball game.
Wow, it is a dogfight. three down. Now four down linemen are going to be rushing to start the second half. They will go to the ground, and it's going to be good yardage out to the 30-yard line for Herod. Second and five from the 30. We just haven't seen that many rushing plays tonight, Jeff, from East Central.
East Central has had some success running the ball until they've gotten to the Wichita side of the 50-yard line. They have done a lot more passing, and they've had some success with that again until they get to the red zone. They're 0 for 1 in the red zone. They have made a couple of field goals and missed one so far tonight.
And Wichita's had to go to the air more than usual because of a lack of success on the ground. So they will be passing on second down. Herser scrambling, throws it across the middle of the field, wide open receiver, out at the 48, out at the 49, pushes forward into Wichita territory to the Wichita 49-yard line. Wow. How do you let a man get that open right in the middle of the field? It was Greg Howe, Richard.
Well, Herser did a good job of stepping up in the pocket and letting the pressure get past them, and that makes it pretty easy to look down the field and find your receivers. Wichita brought a stunt, but they got upfield too quick, and I like bringing the – a little bit of the twist there up front and getting four men after it, but you got to keep those rush lanes, and that's a little harder to do when you're doing a twist.
You do.
Herser will get out there and run. That time found the open receiver.
That was a 21-yard gain, and just like that, East Central's into Wichita territory, trailing by eight. Herser looking over to his sideline for the play. On first down from the 49, gives to Herod again. Very little that time to the 48-yard line. Gain of only one. Second down and nine from the 48. And I think we're going to be seeing Herser aired out again a lot in this second half, Jeff, frankly.
Not much room to run, you're right. And he has been able to find his targets on a regular basis. Just been able to stop him when it gets near the end zone. Wichita defense bending a bit right now.
Herod the running back, but look for Herser to be passing here with trips to his right, one man to his left. Herser passes right down the line of scrimmage to the right, right between two Tigers. Wow, just missed tackles there down to the Wichita 35, and they will move the chains yet again, Richard, after the Laquan Wells reception.
Well, it's some good blocking out there. Wichita runs those passes into the flat sometimes too, but it's when there's two receivers out there. This time East Central ran into the trip side, so there were two guys blocking instead of one guy blocking out there, and so that allowed the extra block to spring him.
From the 35-yard line, here comes East Central in this one-possession game. Trips near side this time. One man far side from the Wichita 35. Give over right tackle. Herod, 5 yards to the 30. And East Central just pretty relentless to start this third quarter, Jeff, and marching the football down the field.
It looks a lot like the late second quarter, doesn't it? But Wichita is able to step up and stop East Central on that drive. You just wonder how many times the defense can bend but not break.
Second down and five from the 30-yard line. East Central set on the far hash mark. Herser passing left side. This time it was dropped. Threw it in there a little hard and unable to hang on as Greg Howell. So now, Richard, that brings up a very important third and five here.
Yeah, a big third down. I wouldn't be at all surprised to see Herser maybe keep this one. He's had some success keeping it a little bit, but that time it was blocked well. That drop really just hurt him. Otherwise, that probably would have been a first down.
Important play here, third and five at the Wichita 30-yard line. Herser looks over to his sideline for the play. Got Herod set to his left to block on third and five. Herser rolling left, pitching on the option to Herod. Herod tries to turn the corner and does not get there. Going to be about a yard and a half short as Compton brought him down. Ty Compton. Now, what do you do on fourth and short? I think they're going for it, Richard.
Yeah, they are going to go for it. They didn't even really think about it. I think they are going to realize, hey, field goals aren't going to win us this game. So they got to think about some touchdowns. Great job by Compton running down that speed option and getting the tackle. But this is the big play here.
Here we go, fourth and one. Herser calling the signal, looks to his sideline. Herod is his running back, set to his right. Fourth and one. Give to Herod, first down and more. to the 23, and they move the chains again, Jeff. Fresh set of downs at the 23.
Right behind his right guard, who got a good block in. He was able to fall forward, make that first down.
So from the 23, East Central marching down the field. They started back at their 25 and hadn't done anything fancy, Richard. They're just executing right now.
Yeah, they are, but this is the part of the field where it gets a little harder to execute against the Wichita defense. Now, you don't always want to put yourself in a situation like this if you're Wichita, but see if they can keep that record alive of not letting teams in the end zone very, very much.
First down and 10 from the 23. Miles Davis in as the running back now. 4 yards to the 19. So they are in the red zone now after the handoff to Davis. Second and 6 from the 19. Andrew Hayes on the tackle for Wichita. They set up on the near hash mark, moving right to left, trailing Wichita 14-6, but threatening with 9:53 remaining in the third quarter of play. 3 wideouts to the right side, 1 wideout to the left side. Right side is the wide side of the field. Hernser pitches right. Davis running room, 15, down to the 12-yard line. Another first down, Jeff, and they'll move those chains again. Wichita cannot stop East Central at this point.
Really good read by the quarterback. He saw the linebacker moved to the inside to stop him, so he pitched it outside. Enough room there for a first down.
First down and 10. Ball at the Wichita 12-yard line. Trips to the near side. One man split to the far side. First and 10. Straight drop back. Hernser looking left, throwing left into the turf. Second and 10.
Yeah, that one never really had much of a chance. There's a pileup down there. Looks like maybe an injured East Central lineman, though. He's going to be okay getting up. A little surprised they passed the ball there, Rex, because the passing had been softening up that interior of the Wichita defense, and the run had been working the last few. And yeah. Now they pass there, and it's incomplete. It's all of a sudden second and 10. If they had run, you know, they've been getting 3 or 4 or 5 yards a chunk the last few plays.
Everything's been working on this drive for East Central so far. Let's see if Wichita can stand up here. Second and 10, ball at the Wichita 12. East Central only trails by 8 with 9:06 left in the third quarter. Hernser passing again, goes into the end zone, incomplete. It was on the near sideline, the Wichita sideline. Intended receiver again was Greg Howe. Now, Jeff, they face a 3rd and 10. At the Wichita 12.
They brought in 2 tight ends lined up on the right side. Looked like it might be a run to the right side. Instead, he rolled left and threw across the field to the 1-yard line, but just threw it too wide, and the receiver really had no chance.
Wichita sends in an extra linebacker as Tommy Crompton races onto the field. 3rd down and 10 from the 12. Set on the far hash mark. Hernser again looking to pass, runs it right up the middle of the field to the 5, down to the 3, and that's enough for a first down and goal. They'll mark it at the 2 for East Central.
Yeah, got hit pretty hard, but that's what we said. When you get upfield and you don't keep your rush lanes, he can get out and run on you, and that's exactly what he did that time. Just scurried up the middle, looked like he was going to get in for the touchdown. Wichita stopped him, but now they're in business. They got first down inside the 5-yard line, as they're going to give him about the 2-yard line.
Holy cow. 3rd and 10, and he gains 10.5 yards, Jeff.
Yeah, he really took a big hit. He was brave to stick his nose in there, but he needed that extra 0.5 yard, and he got it.
He got it. 10.5 yards and a first down and goal, and here comes East Central. Knocking. Will they get in? Herod, the running back. Herod over left tackle. Is he in? He is not. 2nd and goal from the 1-yard line.
Looked like he was going to have enough push at first, but Wichita was able to fight back and keep him at the 1. Well, now they're going to signal touchdown.
Wow.
That's
the
very
latest call in history, isn't it?
Yeah, the official that marked him down changed it to touchdown at the last minute.
You've got to make a call faster than that. Good golly.
Well, he marked him down. I've never seen him mark down and then overturn it like that.
Me neither. So touchdown East Central Oklahoma. And here will come Lopez to try to cut this lead to 1.
I think they're going to go for 2, actually, here, Rex.
Yeah, I think they are. They're going to try to tie it right here. So this could be a big play when all is said and done. See if Wichita can get a stop from the 3. Hernser from the near hash mark. coming out of the shotgun, rolling to his right, looking toward the end zone, throwing incomplete. Incomplete. Ouachita stops the two-point conversion, and the lead is still at two.
And Jax Miller leveled Hernser, and he's not good getting up.
It is Ouachita 14, East Central Oklahoma 12. We've got a battle in Arkadelphia. 7:47 remaining in the third quarter. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Joe Couch. Thank you for watching the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Anthony Sherez. Thank you for tuning in to Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Terrell Gibson. Thanks for watching Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Kendall Gibbons. Thanks for watching Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
Missed field goal by East Central, looking awfully big now at the end of the first half, Richard.
Well, and we talked about in the break, too. They're going to be chasing that missed. They could have hit an extra point there. That 1 point could play big later. Hernser was injured going off the field. The hit was not as hard as I initially thought when I looked at it again, and almost looked like he may have hurt it on the throw. We'll see if he's okay to come back in. He was kind of holding his arm.
We see Zaylin Falls returning a kick for the first time in 3 weeks. Good to see him back out there.
He was actually the last kick of the first half. He was out there too, but they kicked it into the end zone, so he did not have a chance to return it.
Justin Dean also deep for Ouachita, but Falls is such a weapon. And this is going to be returnable. He is at the 10. He's at the 15. Trying to break a tackle. Does not. Not much there. Good coverage by East Central. Out to the 19. First down and 10. And Richard Ouachita is going to have to just find some way to get his running game going. T.J. Cole had 232 yards 2 weeks ago. 230 a week ago, or on Saturday. And 25 in the first half.
Well, there's still a long way to go in this one. They still can establish that. Some of that, they had to work out some blocking stuff up front. I wouldn't be surprised at all to see him have a big second half.
They will come out of the pistol. Boy, they're going to need him more than ever right now. There's a good surge from his line. That's how you like to start, Jeff, with about 6 yards on first down, second and four.
They did move the line of scrimmage, and he was able to move forward himself. They called knee down at the 25. That's still a good run on first down.
Yep, 6 yards. Second down and four, Ouachita with a narrow 14-12 lead. 7:14 left in the third quarter. Tigers out of the pistol. Riley Harms, the quarterback. T.J. Cole, the running back. Cole breaks a tackle close to a first down. Let's see where they spot him down. They'll spot him about a yard short, Richard. Tigers obviously don't need to go three and out here. I would expect Cole to get it again.
Yeah, I think he'll get it again. And they're going to bring Givens in, but Washington's going to keep it on the ground, you would expect, here on third down and one. That's their identity. They need to be able to get that in this game.
Third and one from the 28. Lead has been cut to two in this third quarter of play. Kendall Givens, now the running back. He is a sophomore from Little Rock Christian. He will get the direct snap on third and short. Givens looking over right guard. He's got it. Good job, Givens. He knows how to follow that big offensive line, knows just what he needs for the first down, Jeff, and they do move the chain to the 31-yard line.
You know, for a big back, he's got an unusual ability to really move laterally, and that helps him find a hole when there's not one immediately there. He's also patient, waits on the blockers, and he got the first down.
First down and 10, Ouachita working from its 31. Tigers working near hash mark. Pitch out into pass out into the flats. Very short gain for Justin Dean out to the 34. That's just three, Richard, second and seven.
Yeah, not really as much as they were hoping to get on first down. That was a good reaction by the ECU defense. T.J. Cole back into the game for the Tigers here.
Boy, just so impressed with this East Central team that lost its first two games and has since won six straight. So Wichita with eight consecutive wins, East Central with six consecutive wins. Give this time, right side out to the 38-yard line goes T.J. Cole. That's another four, but Jeff, it brings up another big third down play, third and three Wichita.
The Tigers still on their own side of the field, not in four down territory, I don't believe, so they're going to make all of it on this play.
Third and three. They go upstairs here, Richard.
I think they're going to keep it on the ground, but I don't think it's going to be a normal run up the middle.
It's T.J. Cole set to the left of his quarterback with Connor Flanagan to his right. They are going to pass. Pass too high. Good golly. Missed his intended receiver, Riley Harms did, and they're going to have to punt the ball back to East Central. It was Tucker Swoboda, and Jeff, East Central's going to get it back with a chance to take the lead for the first time tonight.
Yeah, that was a good play, good pattern. He was open, but Harms, who has been very accurate tonight, 9 for 13 passing in the first half, looked good earlier on this on a pass to Dean, that time just over the head of his receiver, incomplete.
Yeah, just way too hard and too high. Joe Couch punts it away. Couch gets off another beauty. Takes a Wichita bounce. Boy, dangerous catch made down there to keep it from bouncing further by East Central's Laquan Wells, but he does hang on to it. And this Wichita defense really needs to step up here, Richard, or yet East Central is going to have its first game of the night otherwise, first lead of the night otherwise.
Yeah, they hopefully made some adjustments there. They made some at halftime, surely, but then after that next drive, they need to come out and make a stop because the offensive drive did not do what they were hoping for there. We got a timeout on the field.
14-12 Wichita. Wichita football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years. But long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help. To be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
Wichita has the lead, but East Central has some momentum right now.
That they do, 14-12 in East Central, which went and scored to start the third quarter, has the ball back after forcing a Wichita punt. Hernser, who was a little shaken up, is back in there now with Miles Davis as his running back from the 18. Give to Davis. Davis turns the corner, got a blocker, got a first down, got even more than that, out over the 30, out over to the 32. That's 14 yards to start the game, Richard, and East Central just controlling the line of scrimmage to start this third quarter.
Well, they came out a definite power formation that time, and Wichita did not match the power. Almost looked like they were ready for a pass, and they got beat off the line of scrimmage and got Davis out to the outside, and then it was pretty easy running.
Yes, sir. Again, they are just outplaying Wichita at this point in the football game. From the 32-yard line, back on the ground again, not much there that time for Miles Davis as the tackle is made by Dante Gibson. Senior night at Cliff Harris Stadium, and they're going to need some seniors and others to step up in the second half, Jeff, Wichita is.
No doubt about it, ECU with an opportunity to take the lead even with a field goal. They have quite a good kicker. He's missed one, but he's made two tonight.
Second down and nine. Hernser with Davis as his running back. Two wideouts to the right side, one to the left side, also a tight end to the left side for East Central. Hernser rolls right, looking, passing, got a receiver at the 40, out close to another first down. I think they're going to give it to him, Richard. They are.
And he was sitting in the same spot for about 5 minutes out there. Wichita was all around, just not picking him up right there. And as Hernser ran out there, it's kind of an easy pitch and catch. You got to see the guy open in the middle of the zone there. Like I said, he wasn't moving. He was just waiting on Hernser to come to him, and that was an easy pass.
Move those chains again, and very quickly they have moved from their 18 to their 41, the Tigers of East Central. So from the 41, trailing Wichita by two, here comes East Central Oklahoma, moving right to left from the far hash mark. Two wide receivers to the right, but they'll go on the ground this time. Being strung out is Miles Davis, and he's pulled down at the 40. That's a loss of one that time, Jeff, second and 11.
Got a Tiger injured on the tackle. Davis is up, and he's okay, but one of the tacklers injured for the Tigers.
I think that may be Tommy Crumpton.
He's up.
I think he may
Ty
be okay.
Ty Crumpton, isn't it?
Yeah. Sorry, Ty Crumpton. I think he's going to be okay. I think it was just one of those places you don't want to get hit.
Yeah, senior Ty Compton out of Sylvan Hills. So loss of one, second and 11 from the 40. Look for Hernser to go upstairs. Tigers need a turnover. Tigers of Wichita, that is. These are two sets of Tigers tonight. Out of the shotgun, Hernser with Davis as running back set to his left. Trips right this time, one man to the left. So four wideouts for Hernser. Straight drop back, in trouble. Scrambling right, got running room, 45. He is forced out of bounds at the 48-yard line. That is a gain of 8 on the play, and it'll bring up third down and 3.
Thought he was going to be able to get the first down. Proctor did a good job running him down, considering, or maybe that may have been Crumpton, actually, that ran him down, because all the defensive backs were to Hernser, and he's got out and running. That's what we talked about to start the game. He has not run a ton this year, but he's a very capable runner, and he's been hurting Washington with his legs today.
Big play here, Jeff. Third down as they near midfield.
Third down, 3 yards to go. Washtenaw lines up, play some tough defense here.
Third and 3, Hernser out of the shotgun. He's got one running back, that's Miles Davis, but I think he'll be passing here as they near midfield. He will. Straight drop back, Hernser forced out of the pocket. Comes left side, they rushed him, and he threw it away. Way too high for his intended receiver on the play, Jackson Allen, the tight end transfer from Texas A&M Commerce. So they will send in the punting team, although I will tell you, Richard, up here around midfield, this is where you have to watch out for a fake in a close game.
I was thinking the same thing, and Washington's got a returner back, but they pretty well have their base defense other than that out there, as they got linebackers or safeties lined up.
Yeah, in a close game, I wouldn't put it past them. Punter sets up back at his 32-yard line. They will deep snap it, and he will kick it out of there. So we'll see if this Wichita offense can get anything going. Going to be allowed to bounce. Oh, my. Down at the 1-yard line. How about that, Jeff? The Tigers have 99 yards to traverse.
Just cannot make a mistake down here. The ball is almost on the goal line, Rex. It's way inside the 1-yard line.
It was bouncing backwards and then got to the goal line and bounced sideways right there. That hurts.
Talk about turning the field. Boy, Wichita's got to get that running game going. The lead is just 2. 14-12 Wichita. We're already down to the minute 38 mark of the third quarter. What a battle tonight. Out of the pistol will be Riley Harms. T.J. Cole set behind him. Wichita needs Cole to break a long one. He's going to have a pretty good gain out to the 8-yard line. That's how you like to start it right there, Richard, with a gain of 7.
Yeah, and ECU was betting big on those inside gaps, and they came, but he was able to sidestep and get a decent yards and was kind of falling for about 5 of those, Rex, but able to fall forward and get the first down and give him a little bit of breathing room. But I'd be feeding T.J. Cole here.
Yeah, absolutely, and calling on that big offensive line to do what it does. Second down and 3. T.J. Cole, first down and more. Cole out to the 20-yard line, and there's the T.J. Cole we've been waiting for on those last 2 carries, Jeff.
We remember last week he just took over the game in the second half against Southern Arkansas when the Mule Rockers were trying to make a comeback. Now Wichita needs him to help them take control of this game, and that was a good, good run. That was a lot of will on the part of T.J. Cole.
19 yards combined on the last 2 carries. He only had 25 yards in the first half. First down and 10, Wichita. Cole over right tackle, cuts back inside and finds a hole out over the 26 to the 27-yard line. That's another 8 yards, Richard.
Yeah, that's one of those when he cuts back. Sometimes he breaks it as he cuts back against the grain. They did a good job bringing him down, but that's that first down play you like to see. And I think Washtenaw's going to let the clock run out on the third quarter as it's under 10 seconds. And we've got a big fourth quarter coming.
Oh, this is going to be a fourth quarter for the ages, perhaps. Eight straight victories for Washtenaw. Six consecutive victories for East Central Oklahoma. It's Washtenaw hanging on to a narrow 14-12 lead just past the top of the hour. Let's pause for station identification on this, the Washtenaw Football Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Washita Sports Digital Network.
First man down the field, getting ready for the fourth quarter, I should say. It's none other than Peyton Stafford, one of the best offensive linemen in the country. He knows that if Washita will hold its lead and win this game, it'll be because the offensive line takes control in the fourth quarter and blocks for T.J. Cole and for Givens. And he's down there and ready for the action. Peyton Stafford talking to his teammates and the offensive line out on the field.
Boy, I tell you, for the first time, Richard, since the Harding game a month ago, we've got a dogfight in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, we do. We'll see if T.J. Cole can come alive. He's got 64 yards on the ground after only, as you said, 25 at halftime.
Second down and two from the 27-yard line. Cole going to have a first down. Now that offensive line seems to be taking over a little bit here, Jeff. That was 5 yards on that carry.
They are getting some push now, finally. And Cole's carried four straight times from the one all the way out past the 30-yard line to the 32.
Well, you remember that long touchdown drive Saturday in El Dorado, Richard. Cole carried every time but two plays.
Yeah, now that was not a 99-yarder, so I don't know if he'll do that on this drive, but they're definitely going to give him the chance, and they need another big first down play here from him.
That offensive line's got to keep pushing. There is a big pass, and it is caught down at the 37. Fake me out at first, and's got the receiver, Justin Dean, as Washtenaw goes down, but we've got a flag down, Richard.
Yeah, it's down the field, so I wonder if it's like an illegal lineman downfield maybe or something, but I think Harms waited too long to throw that. Otherwise, Dean might could have gone to the end zone. I wonder if the offensive line took off running, thinking it was going to be
Justin Dean with the catch. Let's see what the penalties have just been so hurtful for Washtenaw tonight. Let's see what the call is. Wow, and that's the play they've been looking for right there.
I mean, it's not in the spot where holding normally is.
No, it is not at all.
It's about 5 yards down the field from the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. Oh, you got to be kidding. Unnecessary roughness. That's a personal foul, and that's a killer. That's just not Washtenaw football. That's not the type of thing you usually see on a Todd Knight team, Richard.
Well, we don't know what happened. You don't normally see unnecessary roughness in the middle of the play.
That is 15 yards, guys. You go all the way back to the 17, and suddenly you've got first and 25. If they lose this game tonight, the penalties are going to be a big part of it. Let me tell you. Pass out into flats. Harms threw it too far again. Now you had the running game going, Richard. And now you've got to go back to the air. Harms rushes it, and suddenly you're looking at second and 25.
Yeah, he's rushed a few.
I mean, that penalty could be the turning point of this football game.
Yeah, he's rushed a few of the short passes.
He's
some of the long ones. It's the short passes where he gets in a hurry. Just take a breath and make a pass.
Exactly.
Up there. You got
settle
time,
down. Second and 25 from the 17. Two wide receivers to either side for Washtenaw. On second down, Harms sets up, can't find anybody open. He's got some running room, not a lot, though. Out to the 24, and Jeff, suddenly you're faced with a third and 18. I tell you, that that is the most hurtful penalty we've seen so far this season. I'll just say it.
Well, and because we were watching the pass, I just didn't see why the call was made. It was against T.J. Cole, who was the one they faked it to on the play-action pass. So I'm not sure how a block could have turned into a personal foul, but the official felt it did.
He tossed the guy down at the end of the block.
Third and 18. Harms sets up, got some time. Now he's going deep, got a receiver, can't get there. Just barely overthrew him, and Washington's going to have to punt it back to East Central. They're hot-dogging now. They're feeling it.
That was
they Flanagan dance had around.
A, Flanagan had a beat, but just a little bit overthrown. And that drive had some promise there. And that penalty, Washington's penalties have absolutely killed them today, and that's what's been unusual. They've taken the run game out of play.
If they lose this football game, it's going to be because of the penalties. And, boy, that just hurt. You thought Washington had a makings maybe of a 99-yard drive. Now East Central's probably going to have pretty good field position, Jeff.
Joe Couch once again in a position to make an important punt.
Got a good rush, but Couch gets another good one out of there. It's going to be taken at the 30, right up the middle. Going to be decent field position at the 37. So you call on that Washita defense yet again, Richard, as even a field goal at this point would give East Central its first lead of the night.
Yeah, Washita's only given up 12 points. The defense has really been up to the task tonight. You give up 12 points, 13 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. You feel good about it coming into the ball game, but it's only a two-point game, and the defense is going to have to come alive. This will be a great time to get a turnover. This is not a defense that forces a ton of turnovers, but this will be the time to do it.
So here comes Herdser and company, Washington leading 14-12 with 13:17 left in the fourth quarter. Herdser out of the shotgun. Miles Davis is his running back. Herdser gives to Davis. Davis juking, rolling, and going up over the 40 to the 41-yard line. Gain of 3, second down and 7.
Washington's really just, at this point in the game, you can tell they're playing tight. They're playing like they're the team that's supposed to win this game, and they don't want to lose it instead of playing to win. ECU's playing a little looser.
They are playing much looser. I think they've played better tonight so far, even though they trail. Let's see if Washington can find a way to hang on in this fourth quarter. On second down, Herdser, straight drop, sets up in the pocket, gets away from the Tigers, going to run for a first down. Wow, move those chains yet again. As he goes out of bounds at the 49, first and 10, Jeff, and they'll have another fresh set of downs.
Got to give a lot of credit to Herdser tonight. He has competed so well, throwing the ball well, running well. When he cannot find an open receiver, he's still been able to make yards.
And a Tiger shaken up over there. He'll come out under his own power.
Was that Josiah Johnson, the safety?
Yep.
He's on the ground for a minute. He's able to run now across the field, so hopefully he'll be okay.
But it is a first down out at the 49. So here comes East Central nearing midfield again, Jeff, with a fresh set of downs.
Now, we've said it before, a turnover would really help the momentum switch back to Washington right now.
Herdser out of the shotgun. His running back is Miles Davis, set to his right. Four down linemen for Washington. Give to Davis. He gets out of there. How on earth did he get past four Tigers? To the 45, gain of 6.
It was a good read option, and he fooled the Herdser fooled four Tigers. You heard Casey Modell talk about that in the coaches show today with Todd Knight. He runs a good read option, and that time he did. And it's a great first down play, and East Central's picking up where they left off. They've been moving the ball.
Second and 4, here they come, trying to take the lead with 11:52 left in the game. Washita only leading by 2 at 14-12. Herdser out of the shotgun. Give right, big hole to the 35 of Washita. Goes Miles Davis. And, Jeff, they move those chains again.
Yeah, momentum has a lot to do with this. The defense has played well for East Central. The offense is moving the ball now, and they can smell a lead here in the fourth quarter.
First down and 10. They'll spot it at the 36 as East Central nears the lead in the fourth quarter. They trail 14-12, clock running, 11:20 left, fourth quarter. Two wideouts to the left, one wideout to the right. Miles Davis, the running back. Davis breaks a tackle again. And now a flag down in there where you're usually going to see a hole, Richard.
Yeah, that was a hole on the interior of the line. So they've been able to overcome some of these penalties, though, that's been hurting Washington. This will put them back in a first and 20. We'll see if the defense can make them pay.
clock stops on the penalty. 11:06 remaining in the fourth quarter. And I have a feeling this one's going to come right down to the last play perhaps tonight.
Well, and ECU is starting to run the ball over. They're a team that comes in a very good running offense. In the first half, they didn't really show it. But they're starting to lean on that run game a little bit, trying to run some clock and wear out this Tiger defense. They're trying to do exactly what Wichita does to other teams at the end of games.
First and 20, ball at the 46-yard line. Tiger defense being asked to step up. The Tiger defense in black and purple, that is. Straight drop back. Hernser got time, got an open receiver, but a great open field tackle made it the 46. It was Miles Davis coming out of the backfield, but Richard Ty Compton was there.
Yeah, I don't even think they're going to give him a yard, Rex.
Nope.
I mean, he got nothing. So Compton, that was a big tackle because that's an open field tackle. If Compton doesn't make that tackle, then there's room to run. But
they're going to give him 1 yard. Second and 19. So second and long. Hernser will be passing again from the Wichita 45. Let's see if this Wichita defense can step up. It's getting late, folks. 10:15, the clock running. Wichita lead is only 2. Hernser out of the shotgun. Straight drop back. Has time across the middle. Has a receiver. Down to the Wichita 30. Where are they going to spot it? Right there at the first down point at the 31.
They're going to give him a first down. I think that's a great spot. It looked like he stepped out of bounds about 2 yards behind that.
Well, at the 26, I mean. Yeah, right by the marker. And they got it. Can you believe that, Jeff? They went from second and 19 to first and 10.
I tell you what, when those receivers turn around and wait for the ball, the defense has got to get there to make the hit as soon as the ball gets there. Instead, they're able to turn around, dodge the defender, and get yardage. That was a slow reaction from the defense.
Wow. Second and 19, and they get the first down. On first and 10, Hernser's got running room up the middle to the 15, to the 14-yard line. It almost feels inevitable now, doesn't it, that East Central's about to take the lead.
Well, in the red zone it gets tougher, but Hernser's been killing Wichita running, especially in the second half, and he did it in the red zone the last time. Is they're sending everybody back to watch the receivers, only sending 3 men on a rush, maybe 4, but if he gets past those 4, he's got green in front of him. It's not something he's done a ton this year, but he's doing it today.
Dawson Miller on the tackle after a 12-yard gain. So first down in the red zone. Hernser with one running back set to his right. He will give over right tackle, and not much there that time. For Jawan King, he is a junior out of Atlanta, Texas. Transfer from Rice University. They give him to the 12, second and 8. And this clock becoming a factor now, Jeff, as it's all the way down to 8:33.
They are eating up time by running the football. Only 2 passes on this drive.
Second and 8 from the 12-yard line. Hernser brings his team to the line. Certainly they're in field goal range, which have given the lead, but they're smelling touchdown now. On second down, Hernser passing into the end zone. One-on-one coverage broken up.
Good coverage by Andrew Hayes down
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely. Hayes was right there on it all the way and broke it up. Intended receiver on the play was Jake Berry. So now it is 3rd and 8. Let's see if Wichita can get another stop here, Jeff, and at least force the field goal attempt.
Vitally important, and checking back into the game after having been injured is Johnson, Joshua Johnson, back in.
So biggest play to this point in the second half. 3rd and 8 from the Wichita 12. Miles Davis is the running back. 2 receivers left, 1 right. Hernser looking left, now looking back right, in trouble. Now he's running for it. He's to the 5, he's to the 3. First down and goal to go. Holy cow.
Unbelievable job by the quarterback. He should have been sacked. Now he's limping as he gets up, but he's just been a Superman for East Central tonight. He escaped 2-3 tacklers. Should have been sacked, Richard, but he got a first down inside the 5.
Yeah, Wichita missed about 3 tackles on that play, and one of them, they had a defender knock the other defender off of him, but Hernser's killed him running the football. And they had trouble last week with O.B. Jones running the football, too. Running quarterbacks can give this team some trouble.
Oh, very poor tackling efficiency for a 2nd game in a row. So now first down and goal. They had the sack, and he somehow got out of there. Superman Hernser. He gives to Miles Davis. Davis pushes forward to the one. Second and goal. Unless they decide to wait about 4 minutes and call it touchdown again like they did earlier in the half.
Yeah, they're keeping this one now at the one. That was a pretty good push.
Second and goal from the one. East Central on the verge of taking the lead. Clock running. 7:10. Wichita looks like it's going to have to come from behind if it wants to stay undefeated. Hernsard looks over to his sideline. Miles Davis is his running back from the one-yard line. Hernser gives to Davis. Davis leaps into the end zone. Touchdown. And East Central has taken the lead with 6:50 left in the football game.
Good job by Davis going over top because Wichita had penetration. And this is the latest in the game Wichita's trailed this year. So they're going to have to – East Central's going to go for two to make it a – 5-point game? It doesn't make
it a 6-point game.
Oh, 6-point game, yeah. So
yeah, so then your extra point would have to be made if you scored a touchdown. But Wichita has only scored 2 touchdowns tonight. This is a team that has scored over 60 3 different times this year, but East Central has just taken it to Wichita so far here tonight.
East Central's going to talk about it.
All right, we'll pause. 2-point conversion coming. Wichita football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network. Touchdown, Wichita!
Play up at the buzzer. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes.
And an 18-14 lead over Wichita, 6:50 to play in the football game, and East Central will now line up and try a 2-point conversion.
East Central has taken the lead on undefeated Wichita. If Wichita's going to go to 9-0, it's going to have to come from behind in the final 7 minutes of the game. 2-point conversion play out of the pistol. Miles Davis will set up behind Kenny Hernser as they set up on the far hash mark. Hernser rolling to his right. He will not get to the end zone as the tackle is made by Wichita. Still, a field goal is not going to do it. It is going to take a touchdown. Does this Wichita defense have what it takes? We're about to see. It is East Central, Oklahoma 18, Wichita Baptist University 14, 6:50 remaining in the game. Wichita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
If you or a loved one gets hurt in an accident, you need true care and concern. You can hand us everything, the bills, the paperwork, and anything else you need help with,
so you can focus on recovering from your injury.
That's why people turn to the Taylor King Law Firm.
You need an attorney with integrity and experience in dealing with the complex details.
We do everything we can to relieve the stress and take care of your family.
If you're injured in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
We'll be on your side, by your side.
Seconds left for the Wichita Tigers to try to come from behind and win this football game. They are trailing late in the game for the first time all year long. Wichita 9-0 trying to win again, or 8-0 I should say, trying to win again, but trailing right now 18-14 against East Central after a 12-play, 62-yard touchdown drive by the Tigers of East Central Oklahoma.
So the Wichita offense, Richard, has been shut out in the second half so far.
Well, a lot of it's been penalties. When they get themselves in first or second longs, they've not been able to overcome it. ECU's gotten themselves in a few, but they've been able to overcome it. Wichita a moment ago was in first and 25, couldn't overcome it.
Yeah, they've got to cut out the penalties here. This one's going to be taken at the 10. Justin Dean at the 20, at the 25, up to the 30, pushes forward, nice return. up to the 34-yard line. So, Jeff, they start out 66 yards from the promised land.
That return showed some gumption from a senior. Dean didn't want to lose this game. He's going to stay in for the offense now. And they've got Cole coming back in the game. Harms at quarterback. They know they've got to have a touchdown. They've got enough time. They've got to execute.
First down and 10, Ouachita from the 34. T.J. Cole, the senior running back, set behind his quarterback, Riley Harms. Give is to Cole. Cole's got running room, and he fumbled it. Ouachita back on it at the 38. Oh, and T.J. is upset at himself, but fortunately, Swoboda was there to get on it, Richard. Hunter Swoboda, or that might have been ball game.
Well, that's the third fumble Washington's had. They've only lost one, but one of them absolutely killed a drive. That one luckily didn't move that much further back, but they probably lost 2 yards on that fumble.
Second and six from the 38. Cradle that ball, TJ. And run, son, run. Let's see if he can find an opening. Washington's going to pass this time. Nope, nobody there. Now he's going to toss it down there and just throw it away. And just like that, Richard, you're back in third and long, third and six.
Well, it was a two-receiver route. It is a two-receiver route on the other side of the field, and the Harms rolled to this side of the field. But that never had a chance because the blocking wasn't there. But two-receiver route, both receivers were double-covered down the field, and there's no backup option at all. There's just nothing for Harms to do there. And that's a third and long passing situation. This is a big play for the Tigers. I mean, they just look lethargic right now.
Oh, the offense is totally out of sync. East Central leading, clock down to 6:01. 18-14 East Central. Need a big play right here. Third down and six. Harms, straight drop back. Sets up, incomplete. Time to punt it away.
Yeah, pass behind Swoboda. He was there for the first down, but it's behind him.
Yep, bad pass. This has not been Riley Harms' night. Fourth and six. They'll punt it back to East Central. Tigers need a three and out, but
well, Harms was great.
Not looking good for Ouachita. I don't think this is their night.
He was great in the first half, but then the second half, especially the short passes, have really just gotten away from him. He's just hurrying things up a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. He's been pressing badly in the second half. It's like the pressure of 8-0 is suddenly getting to him.
Well, and the run game's not there.
Not at all. So Couch will punt it away. East Central's been the better team so far tonight. It's not over yet. Ouachita downs it down at the 2-yard line. So now they need a turnover, Jeff.
Couch just continues to contribute.
Oh,
when they need a long kick, they get one. When they need one inside the 20, they get one, and that one was knocked out at the 3.
Media timeout, and Ouachita still behind, and they do not have the ball. We'll pause. 5:47 left in this one. It's East Central, 18, Ouachita 14. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
This is Joe Couch. Thank you for watching the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
They just called it too soon. You got to call it after they've had some good running plays. The fourth quarter, and ECU has the lead and the ball. It's 18-14, ECU over the Tigers, but Ouachita has them backed up. We'll see what will happen with the defense.
Boy, this defense badly needs to force a three and out here. Give on first down, no gain. In fact, it's a loss for Miles Davis as he went backward. Boy, if you could force a punt out of that end zone, Richard, you would probably have very good field position.
Ball's back, what is it, the 1.5-yard line?
Yep.
Ouachita wants safety, too.
Yeah.
Pay attention to Hernser running the football here.
Yep. Second down and 12 from the 1. He lost 2 yards, Miles Davis did. Watch out for Hernser. Don't lose him. Hernser passing right side. It is intercepted! It is intercepted by Ouachita. The Tigers have come up with it. It is Andrew Hayes, and Washington's going to have it in the red zone.
Andrew Hayes several times tonight has had perfect coverage, and Rex, it looked like he was running that route. That was a great catch. What coverage by Andrew Hayes, and momentum has flipped now, but Wichita still got to go score with 5 minutes left here. Game's far from over.
Far from over. Not the red zone. Got a little ahead of myself there. So it's going to be the 27-yard line, but they're 27 yards away, Jeff, from the promised land. They need a touchdown. Field goal won't do it.
Direct snap to Cole.
T.J. Cole, see if the senior can take over. T.J. Cole forces his way forward to the 21. That was a hard run. Gain of 6, second and 4.
Well, you know he wants to make up for that penalty and then the fumble a minute ago that they were able to get back on. But you want to make up for it, but at the same time, you can't press.
You just
got to play within yourself. When you press, something bad happens. But
yeah, got to play your offense.
I think Washington's going to keep the ball on the ground here.
You would think so. They're going to go with the direct snap to Cole. Just put it in the hands of the senior All-American and say, go win the football game for us. T.J. Cole, this time, got a bit of a hole over left tackle and close to a first down. Jeff, I think they're going to spot him about a yard short.
They were pushing and pushing to try to get that yard, and the whistle blew before he got there.
Third and one, Richard. But, of course, you're in four down territory here. Field goal can't win this one.
Yeah, he was a little loose with the football there. Hold that a little tighter, but I think Washington's going to go with the same play, a direct snap here on third and one. This is what's worked for him all year. You trust it here.
Third down and one. Ball at the 18. Again, the direct snap to T.J. Cole on third and one. T.J. Cole, this is going to be close. Going to depend on the spot here.
I don't think you're going for it on fourth down anyway.
Yeah. Well, you hate for it to come down to fourth down, though.
Not a great spot. I think they may
have to measure. Yeah, fourth down. Wow. So it's coming down to fourth down, guys.
Well, I don't think we have to wonder what's coming. I think it's still going to be T.J. Cole running the football.
Fourth and less than a yard at the 18. Wichita trailing 18-14 with 3:21 left in the game.
I think Wichita may have asked for a measurement just for the chance to get a timeout here.
Yeah, Wichita is going. I think they took a timeout, didn't they?
No, they asked for a measurement.
Oh, they just asked for the measurement. Okay.
And so that's going to give them time to talk about it. Looked like they were starting to send Kendall Givens in the ball game. I know T.J. Cole's not going to like that. Givens is very good in short yardage
situations. Yeah, you've got to go with what's going to get you the first down here. This could be ball game. This is very close. I think it's not that much, Mr. Referee. He put his hands up. It's actually just inches away.
Yeah, maybe a foot at best, I feel.
Yeah. Wow. Jeff, you got to go get it. That's all there is to it. Fourth and less than a yard from the 18.
Looks like Cole is going to check back in.
Fourth and less than a yard. Wichita, 8-0. East Central, 6-2. East Central leading 18-14. 3:21 remaining in the football game. The direct snap is going to go to T.J. Cole, the senior All-American out of Pleasant Grove, Texas. Fourth and less than a yard. Cole will take the direct snap. Man in motion. Cole over right tackle. He's got all kinds of room. He goes to the 6-yard line. First down and goal to go, Wichita.
Wichita's been one of the best short yardage teams in the conference, if not the country, this year, and you just rely on it. You say they're not going to stop it two times in a row, and T.J. Cole almost pushed his way to the end zone there.
Now you're 6 yards away from the promised land. 2:54, 2:53, 2:52, clock running. Tigers trailing 18-14. Yet again, the direct snap will go to T.J. Cole. Wichita sends a man in motion right to left. Cole going right, cutting back inside, nothing that time. May have lost a yard. He did. He lost a couple, Jeff. Back to the 8. Wow.
And tackled him around the neck that time, and he immediately went down. Couldn't fall forward as we normally see from Cole.
Second and goal from the 8 now as Richard goes down, and we're going to have a timeout on the field. We will bring in Michael Westbrook. So, Michael, what do you do here from the 8-yard line? Do you keep going with direct snaps to T.J. Cole?
I like the fact that the ball is in the hands of T.J. Cole. I think you might need to put your quarterback in there just to mix it up a little bit. But all year long, Washtenaw's been able to say, this is what we're going to run, and we're going to run it right down your throat. But East Central's had the answer most of the night. So I think you got to get your quarterback back out there at some point.
Second and goal from the 8. Again, a field goal is not going to do it. You've got to have a touchdown here, Jeff. So you're in 4 down territory. You've got 3 plays to make 8 yards, but boy, you hate for it to come down to 4th down.
You would hate for that to happen, but this is a golden opportunity after the interception, and the clock is ticking away at 2:20. So now with the ball back at the 8-yard line, they're going to send the offense back out there, and it looks like Cole's going to continue to get the direct snap.
Second down and goal, ball at the 8-yard line of East Central Oklahoma. And yes, they will go with the direct snap to T.J. Cole. Cole, the senior, out of Pleasant Grove. Got a hole this time. Goes to the 3. Goes to the 2. Goes to the 1. To the promised land. Washington is back on top.
What excellent blocking on the right side. Good reading of those blocks, a broken tackle, and then a sprint to the end zone.
T.J. Cole. Now the all-important extra point to make it a 3-point lead where a field goal can't beat you. It could only send you to overtime. And this is a freshman, Dax Jaggers, that has to do it. Because remember, Gabe Goodman has been out now, Jeff, for 3 games with a groin strain.
And now a procedure call against Washtenaw. Him up by 5.
A false start. We had that twice last week against Southern Arkansas.
Oh, my goodness. This is important, guys. This is important. You need this lead at 3. Jaggers, the extra point from 5 yards back. Snap, hold, kick, up. Good! So it falls back to the Washtenaw defense now to keep East Central out of field goal range. The clock is down to 1:56, and the Washtenaw lead is 3, 21-18. Washtenaw football 2022. Presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues in 30 seconds here on the Washtenaw Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
Washita turns a turnover into a 27-yard touchdown drive in 6 plays, all runs by Cole, and now Washita has a 3-point lead.
And this one is fair caught. And so it is up to the Washita defense at this point. A field goal will tie it, and they've got a good field goal kicker. He's already hit one from, what, 45 tonight, Jeff?
Yes, and he's got a leg. He can really, really kick, but Washtenaw's got to defend to avoid a touchdown. There's plenty of time for ECU.
And 49, Rex. 49 and 45.
Yeah, 45 and 49. And a touchdown will win it, of course, for ECU. So here come the Tigers of East Central with trips to the near side. Herzer an empty backfield. Sets up, forced out of the pocket. Rolling right, looking downfield. Got a receiver. Intercepted again at the 50. Brought back to the 45. Brought back to the 40. Brought back to the 35, the 30, the 25, the 20, 15, 10. Down to the 3-yard line. Washtenaw.
Oh, my. He made a beautiful play. He was guarding a man in the flat, but he saw the quarterback's eyes go deep, and he sprinted deep and got there just as the ball did. He went high, he got the interception, stayed on his feet, and then made an amazing return inside the three.
Mario Gunter Jr.
Freshman from El Dorado, got to play last week in front of his hometown and here in front of his home fans. What a play.
First down and goal from the three. Direct snap, T.J. Cole to the one, to the promised land. Touchdown, Washington. And just like that, it's a two-possession lead. Have you ever seen a game turn around so quickly?
Oh, my gosh. The crowd was so quiet for so long, and they really came alive here late in the fourth quarter. What an amazing performance by the defense, and the offense again, as Ouachita has scored two quick touchdowns.
Extra point by Jaggers is up. It is good. Oh, my. Ouachita 28, East Central 18 with a minute 33 left in the fourth quarter. Ouachita football 2022. Oh, deep breath continues in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
That was a one-play, three-yard drive after the interception. Hernzer, his last two passes, both interceptions, both led to touchdowns, and Ouachita leads it by 10, 28-18, 1:33 left in the game.
Boy, two huge interceptions by this defense. Down the stretch, into the end zone and out, first and 10 from the 25. Hernzer, of course, will be passing again, and it's just up to the defense. I mean, you don't want to give up a touchdown here because you've got a two-possession lead, but you don't want this thing coming down to an onside kick now, Jeff.
No, you don't want that.
Still far from over.
You got to make them work for any first down they make. The last thing you want to do is give up a big play quickly.
First down and 10 from the 25. A minute 33 still remaining in the fourth quarter. Ouachita now leading 28-18, running off 14 points just like that. Hernzer in trouble. Sacked back at the 20-yard line. And wow. Anthony Freeman, the junior out of Neville High School in Monroe, Louisiana.
And he is the leader of this defense in many ways. Just got his fourth sack of the year, and what a key time for that one.
Back to the 20, where it is second down and 15. Hernzer will come out of the shotgun. Sets up. Can't find anybody open. He's going to run for it now, and he's tackled immediately, and that clock will keep running as he's down at the 21-yard line. Ouachita there again. It was Dante Gibson. And now, Jeff, we're down to 43 seconds left in this one.
They have two timeouts, and they are not using them, Rex.
Wow. What a fourth-quarter comeback. Ouachita was down and almost out before this defense came up with two turnovers. Hernzer out of the shotgun again. Throws out into the left flats. Incomplete. And now it's third and 15. And we're just 20 seconds away from the end of this one. Fourth, I mean, and 15.
Well, a difference in body language is there for East Central. They look like a defeated team right now, as, of course, they are, with 10-point lead and 20 seconds left in the game. Amazing comeback.
Get the stop here, and let's get in that victory formation and get out of here. They had to work for this one tonight, Michael.
Absolutely, they did. One more play right here, and the defense has stepped up late.
Three down linemen rushing. Hernsert straight drop back. Now he's going to pass on the run. Got a receiver out into the right flats, out to the 33. And he's going to go out of bounds, short of the first down. And Washita's going to be able to run this clock out. And how about it, Dr. Jeff Root? This team is going to be 9-0.
Yeah, it's just pretty amazing, isn't it? Washita just struggled and struggled and struggled. And one big play by Hayes, the cornerback from El Dorado, or I'm sorry, from Bryant, followed by an interception by a young man from El Dorado, Mario Gunter.
Oh, the best formation in football, the victory formation. He downs it. What a night's work. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Paint the GAC championship purple, baby. Washita has at least a share. The Tigers go to 9-0. Another one for you on senior night, Clark Yarborough.
Just couldn't be better. The Washita Tigers, highly ranked, came through.
Here with head coach Todd Knight. Coach Knight, your offense has gotten the headlines all year, but today the defense comes up with the two big plays. Andrew Hayes, the junior, and then on senior night, the freshman, Ganter, gets the interception. I mean, what a play.
No doubt. Did a great job right there. We were good in the red zone. You know, we forced field goals, and that was the difference. And then the turnovers, these guys, they lead the nation in turnover ratio. Man, we were loose with the ball in the first half. So I'm just proud of the guys with the turnover ratio. Winning the turnover ratio is the difference in the game.
Well, and in the first half, the run game wasn't really working. But, of course, your quarterback, Harms, had almost 200 yards passing, really did a good job for you in the first half.
He did, and sometimes you got to do it. You got to do what they give you right there, and that's what we had to do.
It's senior night. Talk about the senior leadership on the sidelines of that game.
Oh, man, I can't say enough about those 18 and those 17 and Clark, too. You know, just including Clark in that as well. Just an amazing group of seniors.
First bit of adversity you've had this year. I know you didn't like it, but there's things that you can learn from this, I'd imagine.
Oh, no doubt, and hopefully we're healthy. I hadn't seen the trainer yet, but if we're healthy and learn a lot right there, we're going to be good.
All right, thanks. Congrats on the win.
Boy, Andrew Hayes, an interception, and then the go-ahead touchdown, and then Mario Ganter Jr., just a freshman. Mario Ganter, remember that name. You're going to hear it a lot out of El Dorado with the big interception, the return all the way to the 3, and then another T.J. Cole touchdown to put it away. T.J. Cole now has the school record with 44 touchdowns, Jeff Root. Congratulations, T.J. But this game belongs to the defense tonight.
It really does. This is a very fine East Central team.
Very.
I mean, they're really good. They'd won 6 in a row. They were 6-2 coming in, and they must feel like they had it in hand until late in the game they decided to throw man-to-man coverage, a deep pass down the sideline, and Hayes made a wonderful interception. And then the same thing happened with the freshman Ganter because he was covering the man in the flat, saw the quarterback look deep. He ran deep, and he got there just before the ball did, went high in the air for the interception, and then a great run back. And Cole, touchdown, interception. Well, interception, Cole, touchdown to end the game, and Washington's a 10-point win.
Yep, so TJ, rushing touchdown that last one, passes Brockton Brown for the school record, but again, the defense tonight is the story with those late interceptions that allowed a T.J. Cole 8-yard rushing touchdown with 1:56 left, and then a T.J. Cole 3-yard touchdown with 1:33 left. Washita ends up winning by 10. And that's deceiving, Michael. This game was close. In fact, Washita looked down and out, down 18-14 late and having to punt the ball back to East Central.
Yeah, the touchdown was 6:50 to go, made it 18-14, and, you know, it was getting really scary there. Washita ends up winning the turnover battle after all of that, won the Hernsert 2 interceptions, and so only the one fumble from Washita early on, and they end up winning the turnover battle, which did end up making a difference in this one, for
and
sure.
Jeff, you talked about it at the time, but as it turned out, another key in this game, Washita's down by 4. They have to punt the ball late Joe Couch gets off a 60-yard punt, and that certainly was one of the plays of the game. And then Hayes comes up with the first of those two interceptions.
Well, the Hayes interception was great defense, but I don't think he would have thrown the ball if he hadn't been standing in the end zone. He had to get rid of it.
Yeah.
And so he threw it deep to his only receiver who was running down the sideline, and Hayes got there first for the interception. So that punt made a lot of difference, and so did the stop on first down. Then he threw it deep, and Hayes made the play of the game.
Wow. Just an incredible comeback for this Wichita team again that really looked down and out at 18-14 late. T.J. Cole, the two late touchdowns set up by the Hayes and the Ganter interceptions tonight. One by a senior or by a junior, Hayes. One by a freshman, Ganter, who likes purple. He played at El Dorado, which wears purple, comes to Wichita, which wears purple, and the Ganter interception really has to be, because they could have gone down, had plenty of time, and sent this to overtime with the field goal. The Ganter interception, in my mind, may be the play of the year so far.
Well, it was a huge, huge play. Because you could say the same thing, I think, about the Hayes interception, because it turned all the momentum to Wichita.
Yeah, both of them.
But I think the two of them were both instrumental. It was a real opportunity with 2 minutes left for ECU to come back before that Ganter interception. Hernzer, by the way, only had three interceptions all year long and two here in the fourth quarter against Wichita.
All right, I'm going to let you find Richard down there if you can, Michael, at some point.
I've got
him when he's ready. Okay.
Just now broken up into their position meetings, so it may be a little bit longer. Hernzer threw the ball 40 times tonight, and he's used to doing that all year long. Eventually, you knew he was due for a mistake, and Wichita got to him twice.
Hey, this team is not a fluke. This team, after losing its first two under a new head coach, comes through and has won six straight going in tonight. And they had the number four team in the country on the ropes, Jeff. But Wichita, which has been ranked in the polls 47 straight weeks, does it. Richard?
And this was a tough game. ECU came in, had won six straight, and really probably did not go the way y'all thought. Really shut down the run game in the first half. But
T.J. Cole's the guest.
Y'all made in the second half. What's got you? First of all, what's got you so emotional right now?
It's my last home run at the Cliff, and I'm gonna miss playing with these guys.
Well, we hope there's one more for the playoffs still coming. But talk about this game, especially in the first half when they're really kind of shutting y'all down. There's a couple fumbles that bog down drives, some penalties. You still have 14, you have the lead, but at halftime nothing really feels settled. In the second half and even into the fourth quarter, it's getting dicey. What was the sideline like?
We just had to stay in the game. Emotions were flaring, but we just had to stay within ourselves and play the game and just stick together.
Well, you punt the ball with 5 minutes left, kind of put it in the hands of your defense, and they come up with a huge play, the big change of momentum. I think everybody in the stadium knew you were going to get it until y'all got down to the end zone. What was the offense saying coming out on the field there?
We got to score, put it in the end zone, and that's what we did.
Well, you scored three touchdowns today. That puts you at number one all-time in Wichita career rushing. I have to go back and check. I think you moved up one spot in career rushing yards. To get records like that on your last home game, how does that feel?
It feels ecstatic. Personally, it feels ecstatic for me, but it's more of a team goal. My offensive line, I wouldn't have none of this. I wouldn't have none of the accolades I would have if it wasn't for them and the coaching staff. So my awards is their awards. So we're thankful. We're thankful for everything.
In a game like this, when the run game wasn't really working, especially in the first half, Riley Arms carried y'all for 200 yards in that first half. What can you say about Riley in this game?
Riley is a technician. He's a general back there. We follow wherever he goes, and he's the leader of the offense, and whatever he says goes, and we're just going to protect him to the fullest and trust him with everything.
Well, you've had the offense. I talked to Coach Knight about this. Offense has kind of gotten the accolades all year long, even though it's been a solid performance, great performance every week by the defense. But they come up with the two game-winning plays. It's got to be kind of fun to see the defense, hey, kind of get their credit and some credit that's due to them for how well they play this year.
No, for sure. We've been talking about it. We've been talking about we gotta get the turnover margin better. We can't put the ball on the ground as much as we did, especially tonight. But defense came up huge tonight with two interceptions.
All right, now you get the weekend off. You get a whole week and a half before you play again. Thursday games are tough, but it's going to feel good, I imagine, to get that week and a half off to get ready for the last two games, which are not going to get any easier than this one.
Oh, yes, sir. We're going to get rested up. We're going to get back to the game plan, and we'll get back to it on Monday.
All right, thanks. Congrats on the win. We'll see you next week.
Thank you so much.
The great T.J. Cole with tears, literally, Jeff, flowing down both sides of his face.
Yeah, it really means a lot to him to play in this stadium. It's his last home game. We're going to say last regular season home game. And a lot of fans were here. A lot of students were here to see it.
Andrew Hayes, man of the minute.
Hey guys, we're starting. We got two defensive backs here. We're figuring out who's going to go first. I'm going to talk to you both at the same time.
Oh, and Andrew Hayes, man of the night.
I'm the first one to talk to you. We saw several times in this game, especially down in the end zone, a few times you're almost running the route with the receiver step for step, but then it really pays off down here on that interception where they lost 2 yards on first down, thought they might be running again, but they go back to pass. Take us through what you saw on that play.
This is Andrew Hayes.
Well, first, I really just saw his feet. He kind of gave me the sense that he was going to try and hurry up and run a fade. I knew they were on the goal line, so they didn't have much time. So that's mainly what I read, and then whenever he gave me it, I just tracked his hip, leaned low, located, and made the play.
Well, it's the team that comes in, leads the country in turnover margin. They forced a couple today, but then all of a sudden y'all are able – well, they had the one fumble recovery, forced a few other fumbles. Wichita only gave it up that one time. So y'all end up plus on the turnover margin at the end of the game. Coming in, playing against the defense, that's good. That's got to feel good as your own defense.
Yeah, it feels real good. We're proud we got the win. I want to give credit to those guys. They're really, really scrappy. They're great on defense, great on offense. It's a great team overall. I'm just glad we came out here and got the win on that.
Yeah, we saw several times. I mean, they're so good. They come in, they're a very good running team. They're passing the ball a whole lot today. And the quarterback's getting out and running, which is something that y'all may not have been ready for, even though you knew that he can run. He just hadn't done it a whole lot. What are some of the difficulties they presented when trying to defend them? Because they've been on a serious roll the last 6 weeks.
Right. Oh, man. Again, I'm going to go back to scrappy. You never know what's going to happen. They're completely unpredictable. You think you got them dead to rights, and then the quarterback scrambles for 20 yards. They use every tool they have, and they just do everything they can to win.
All right, stay here. I'm going to come back to you. I'm going to go to – is it Mario, right?
Mario.
Mario Ganter, yep. Jr., the freshman from El Dorado. So a freshman on the field at the end of the game. There are two defensive backs out there, freshmen. And you get the – so Andrew gets the interception that puts Wichita up. You get the one – hey, they still got 2 minutes left. They could go down a minute and a half. And they did it at the end of the first half, kind of drive the field. And you kind of seal the game there, and everybody on the sidelines yelling, go down, and you take it back to the 2-yard line. So, but take us through what you saw on that play. You went up high to make an interception.
Well, we were in a coverage to put us in the best position. So I was looking at the quarterback eyes the entire time, and he didn't see me underneath on the corner route. And so he was scrambling. I was like, okay, he's about to throw the corner route. I was like, you know, I got to get there in time, and if I don't catch the ball, at least try to tip it, make sure you don't catch it.
Well, I got to admit, when he was throwing, I thought it was going to be too high for you. I thought you might tip it, but you got both hands on it. We've seen throughout the year you get on the field more and more and more. They're working you in the field more and more and more. What kind of confidence do you have and how does it feel the coaching staff has that confidence in you for freshmen getting out there?
Well, it all starts in practice. You got to practice hard every day. You got to understand that at a position like DB, man, you got to have confidence. And if you ain't got confidence, coaches can't trust you put out there. So to me, just day by day, I've seen the coaches trusting me more and more. They're telling me to get more reps in practice. And so for me, that's telling me, hey, I'm a freshman, and they're telling me to get in. So they trust me in some place.
Well, we see the GAC, a lot of teams are becoming kind of like Washington, running more and more and more. And then all of a sudden today you see 4 and 5 wide receiver sets. And I have to look at the stats, but they maybe threw as much as anybody's thrown on y'all all year long. Well, last week they threw a lot too. But what's, coming into kind of going off of some of those games where they've been running, you kind of got to adjust and get ready for a game like that, don't you?
Yeah, like I said, it goes back to practice. A lot of run teams that we play, and then when we get the opportunity to throw the ball, our DB coach always tells us, you know, we're going to run, and then they're going to hit that hole shot. And so you got to be prepared every single rep of every single day, and you can't take one play off because that one play could be the play that gets you.
Well, Andrew, I'm going to come back to you. It's senior day. You're a junior. You've been around for a while, but then so we get a junior and a freshman that kind of make the plays that help seal this one. But talk about some of that senior leadership that was on there on the sidelines and what was a tough game.
We have the best seniors you could ever ask for. The whole line, I'm very close with all the seniors. They're very good at leading. I'm happy that we can come out here and make some plays for them on their night.
Well, and I was talking to TJ, I talked to Coach Knight about this, but this is an offense that's gotten most of the accolades this year. It's a defense that's been playing phenomenal and leads the GAC in scoring defense and all that, but it's often when they put up 60 points, they get headlines. For y'all to come in and kind of seal and win that game, it's got to feel good and fun as a defense.
Yeah, I can't lie to you. It was a pretty electric feeling. I'm glad we came out here and paid them back because they've been averaging a crazy amount of points, and last week I would say that they bailed us out. We gave up 31 points, and that's way too much. So I'm glad we can come out here and seal the deal for them and give them a break.
You ever had an interception that big in a ball game before?
Maybe one. Maybe one a long, long time ago.
Mario, you ever had one that big?
Oh, man, no, not in a long time. I can't remember last time I was in a 2-minute drill and balls coming directly at me, and it's like, hey, you either got to make the play or they're going to make the play. And, oh, my goodness, it felt amazing.
You wanted that end zone bad, didn't you?
Oh, I wanted it bad. My defense did a good job. My teammates did a good job of setting up a wall. But, you know, me in my mind, it's like, oh, I see green. I got to get there. I got to get there. And so I'm zigzagging trying to find a way. But it's all love, man, and I love it.
All right, congrats on the big win. Thanks, guys, for the interview. Yeah.
Wow. I want to tell my fiance that I love you. I don't know where you are.
She's listening somewhere.
She's listening. I want to tell Katie Clifton I love you wherever the camera is.
All right.
Thank you. We got you, Andrew. Wow. A junior and a freshman, and those are your two plays of the year, maybe. Let's go back to Richard.
Here with quarterback Riley Harms. And, Riley, I'll ask you the same thing I talked to them about. I've talked to everybody about, but it's kind of been the offense that's had the accolades all year long. Right, so when you put up 60, but it's been a great defense all year long. But then today, it's a little different seeing them really come and seal the win. So it's kind of flipped, and nice to know that y'all can win a different way.
That's right. We can win a lot of different ways, and that was a heck of a football game. Defense made two huge plays, but that just shows you what the type of team we have. We're really old. We never panic, and we're able to lean into a lot of different things.
Well, in the first half, we saw you light it up. You went for 198 yards in the first half, which is more passing than y'all have a lot of games. Second half, it fell off a little bit, but. First half, it was really clicking. The run game just went there, and there were some penalties, and y'all had to pass. But It seemed like it was really clicking in the first half for you.
Yeah, absolutely. Anytime they're going to give us one-on-one, we're going to take it. Connor Flanagan exploits those matchups every week. He's nearly impossible to stop. So it's really just try to find those matchups with him and throw it up and let him have a chance.
Well, on that one, speaking of Connor Flanagan taking a one-on-one matchup, the 48-yard pass that set y'all up where you ended up running in for the touchdown after that, he completely turned his defensive back around, it looked like, on his route. But take us through that one, and it was a wonderful catch at the end.
Yeah, we needed that. It was 3rd and 10. I think there was just over, like, a minute left, right? So, you know, we're up, like, 7-6 at that point, I think. That was a huge drive. We needed to score. We had just had two incomplete passes, and Connor beat his guy. I told Connor, I think I threw it when he was, like, 15 yards down the field. There was some pressure in my face. I just threw it about as far as I could, let him run under it, and he made a heck of a play.
It was a high one that he Willie Mays won. It's easy to say now, but it's sometimes good to look back and say, okay, it's good to have a little adversity at some point here in the season. Now, you don't necessarily want it while it's happening, but what are some things that you can learn from this and take from this into some other ball games?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we got to be better at adjusting on the fly, right? We came out in the second half, and they changed how they had lined up to a few things that they did in the first half. So we got to be able to adjust, you know, in between possessions better.
When y'all have to punt it away with 5 minutes left, because honestly, I'm not going to sugarcoat it, offense really hadn't been clicking much in the second half at all. Mm-hmm. There had been some penalties that had really been setting y'all back, and those were hard to overcome. When you punt it away with 5 minutes left, that has to be a rough feeling as an offense. But then the quick change of momentum after the negative 3 yards and then the interception. And what's going through your head as y'all are running back out there 2 plays later?
Yeah, I mean, first thing, you always hear the NFL guys talk about it with those quick turnarounds Sunday to Thursday. I mean, I know it's Saturday to Thursday, but it's hard to get in a rhythm. You're used to a routine the whole year, right? You practice Monday through Friday, play Saturday. It's hard to turn around and practice Monday through Wednesday. You know, and obviously East Central, the same thing. But we didn't panic. I trust our defense. We all trust our defense, especially when Joe made that unbelievable punt and went out of bounds at the 2. We knew we were going to win that ball game.
Well, last, let's talk about ECU. What a turnaround they've had from last year to this year, especially on defense. I mean, they're the real deal, and that's one of the tougher teams that you faced, and that's going to be good for down the road.
Absolutely. That's a really good football team. They play extremely hard. Defensively, they get, it feels like, 11 guys to the ball every time there's a tackle. Which is why they force so many turnovers, because, you know, you can kind of get lackadaisical towards the end. They forced a couple fumbles tonight. They're ball hawks, and they play, like I said, they play extremely hard. They've got a lot of old guys that have been playing football for a long time.
Yeah, 3 fumbles tonight, only 1 turnover, though, so you win the turnover battle. Is that something y'all talked about during the week, winning that turnover battle? And y'all were losing it for a long time and losing the game, and then you get 2, and all of a sudden you win the game when you win the turnover battle.
It's funny, isn't it? That was the biggest key point the whole week. Coach Knight said, if we're going to win – in this game, we have to win the turnover battle. I think, I don't know about this week, but going into last week, they led the country in turnover differential, right? So that shows how good of a football team they are.
All right, thanks. Congrats on the win.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
What has been a magical season thus far for Ouachita, and those 2 interceptions late, again, I go back and say they're going to have to be the co-plays of the game, but I think they're the 2 biggest plays of the season thus far, Jeff.
I think that's a fair statement. And we were talking about, you know, maybe we're beginning to think already about can the Tigers bounce back from a loss? And instead, they bounce back late in the fourth quarter and get a win. When
they're
East
trailing
Central,
at the 2-minute mark.
East Central must have thought, this is our game.
Yeah,
Tigers
absolutely
took it away.
Absolutely amazing. We're at the top of the hour. Let's pause for station identification on this, the Ouachita Football Network.
Is it going to be